the
Thank you.
someone has lost a cell phone, you see a cell phone laying around, bring it to the press box, please.
Okay, testing 1, 2, 3. All right, just letting everybody know that the game is being delayed a bit. The team bus for Union County got behind an accident somewhere down the road and were delayed quite a bit, but the bus has just pulled in. I've been informed by Mr. Spencer Mathis. Yes. Is that true, sir?
Yes, sir.
Are you looking forward to the game tonight?
I am a lot looking forward to this game, sir.
And you have it by yourself. You're going to be announcing by yourself tonight.
Yeah, it should be a great game. They're going to give Union County 25 minutes once they get on the field, then the game will start from then.
All right. Well, we certainly hope the best for the people that were in the accident. I understand there might have been a fatality in the accident that they were behind. And so that's why they were delayed. So, unfortunate situation there. We don't know exactly where. Did you hear where?
15 minutes away from here.
15 minutes away, so somewhere below Gainesville, possibly, or maybe to the side. And I'm not sure exactly how they come this way, if they come through Claremont or how they come. But we will be doing the game as soon as they get warmed up. And I think they have several minutes to do that, correct?
Oh, yeah. We've got several. I think they're going to have to go change first, and then they're going to go on the field. But that could just be the band. We don't know if that's the team yet or not.
Okay. So we still are awaiting word of whether the football team has actually arrived. So we're going to stand by here and see what happens here. But we were going to have the game live. We're not able to be on Facebook Live tonight. Apparently our signal's being blocked on there. We have not been able to get on Facebook at all, which is pretty par for the course. I guess most schools try to block Facebook. But we are right here, of course, on YouTube. As you know, you're watching it right here on YouTube.
Thank you. For over 30 years, Carter Insurance and Investments has provided the Union County area with quality and competitive products for life, health, and disability insurance, as well as Medicare supplements. As an investment advisor representative, Carter Insurance and Investments can help you build an investment plan that's best for your financial situation. To learn more, stop by and meet our friendly staff. We're located on Young Harris Street across from the post office in Blairsville.
For years, your source for sales, parts, accessories, and service for golf carts has been North Georgia Golf Carts. Now they're at a new, more convenient location. Owner Rick Goddard and staff are there to assist you with all your golf cart needs. They sell and service all types of golf carts, from Easy Go to Club Car to Yamaha. And they provide pickup and delivery for any service work. That's North Georgia Golf Carts, now located east of Young Harris near the intersection of U.S. Highway 76 and State Highway 17 North. When you combine quality products, excellent customer service, and the best prices in the area, the result is Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing. In business since 1963, Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing has served the surrounding area with a variety of home improvement supplies. Everything from vinyl siding in many colors, trim pieces, shutters, soffits, vents, and accessories. Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing, located west of Blairsville on Highway 515.
Locally owned since 1980, Leon's Flooring is your full-service flooring store with the largest showroom in the area, guaranteed to save you money with over 50 years of total sales experience. The folks at Leon's Flooring are experts in ceramic tile, carpet, hardwoods, and vinyl. Located at 568 Murphy Highway in Blairsville, next to the Mexican restaurant and across from Mike's Seafood. Leon's Flooring, call them today at 706-745-9433. Oh, and by the way, say hello to Diesel while you're there.
Constantly challenging ourselves as a college means more learning opportunities, better teaching, more innovative programs, greener facilities, a stronger community, and happier students. Every choice we've made reinforces our mission to help educate, inspire, and empower you. Young Harris College, this is the place where your future unfolds.
For years, Bitter Creek Market has been the best little market in the mountains. Now they're even bigger and better with additional room for specialty foods, vegetables, and frozen foods. But don't worry, Bitter Creek Market still has the best selection of quality meats in the area. Their professional butchers prepare the best cuts of meats daily right on site, and Bitter Creek Market grinds their own sausage using only quality cuts of meat. For the gourmet cook, Bitter Creek Market has a wide selection of high-quality food items. And don't forget Bitter Creek Market's Deli. Stop by for freshly made sub sandwiches and pork barbecue smoked right on site. They even have homemade potato salad. And they have picnic tables by the creek for your dining convenience. Bitter Creek Market is open Monday through Saturday. Come by and see the friendly staff today. Bitter Creek Market. The best little market in the mountains.
Well, she has a boyfriend for one. But.
Yeah. And yeah. I don't know. I still.
You just don't find her attractive?
I've just known her forever.
Oh.
I just think to myself, no.
Huh?
I just think to myself, no. Go!
Again, letting everybody know that we have a delay in the game. The Panther bus was caught behind an accident on the way here, and they've been delayed quite a bit. We don't think they've actually arrived yet. The Panther football players have not arrived. So we're going to have quite a bit of delay here, maybe 45 minutes, maybe longer. Maybe less, just depends on. We know when they get here, obviously, they're going to have to warm up and go through all of that routine. So it will be quite a wait here. So stay tuned, and we'll try to get to the action whenever it gets here. Until then, Spencer is going to tell us some jokes.
Airline food, am I right?
What's that?
Airline food, am I right?
Yeah, that's a joke. Okay. It is. We should do like a podcast here.
Yeah.
But I don't know anything about sports.
I could tell you what a first down is. Touchdown, 6 points.
Yeah, I mean, I know that much. I know what a first down is.
What do you not know? You know what a safety is?
When they are in the end zone and they throw a pass and it's 2 points. Is that right?
Nope. No. It's where the quarterback gets sacked in the end zone or the running back gets pushed back into his own end zone. That equals 2 points for the other team.
I did not know that. But now what is it when they're in the end zone, they're trying to kick a field goal, and they get – oh, that's just called a two-point conversion.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've learned something today.
Yeah.
I mean, I haven't been covering football for how many years have I been doing football? Man, that's a long time.
Yeah.
30 years?
Yeah.
Probably longer.
It is crazy.
So what do you think about your brother getting the job in Florida?
I think that's a W for Chris.
He's always wanted to do that. So, yeah. I mean, I think that's a really cool thing.
Yeah.
He worked hard. He applied himself. Put his nose to the grindstone and made it happen. That station is what, WDAE? 95.3, I believe.
Yeah, that's right.
You're listening to 95.3 WDAE.
Yeah.
Maybe you think I could get a job down there as an announcer, maybe?
Yeah. Probably football.
But I don't know anything about football.
You just learned what a safety was.
Okay. I think it takes more than that. I'll stick to the camera work and the technical work. I think I'll just do that.
Just become an announcer, a color analyst.
John Madden type?
Yeah. I believe.
So, was it true that when you and Chris were growing up, you guys would sit in front of the TV and, like, imitate the announcers? Is that how y'all got into this?
Yes.
And who was your favorite team? So who would you watch?
We watched a lot of Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Well, you grew up there, right?
No.
No?
No. Chris was born in St. Pete. And then whenever he turned like four, we moved here. So he was there for 4 years in the Florida area.
Oh, but you've always gone and visited.
We've always been in Union.
But you visited. You have relatives there.
Yeah. Yes. And they all survived the hurricane.
Excellent. Yeah. I was going to ask that. Now Chris had to relocate during the hurricane,
yes.
I believe.
Yes, he relocated to North Florida, and nothing hit North Florida. He was fine.
All right, for those of you who don't know, we're talking about Chris Mathis, and we're here with his brother, Spencer Mathis, who's going to do play-by-play tonight. I'm John C. Moon, cameraman extraordinaire, I guess. And we're just killing time until the football team gets here, and I see a bus pulling in right there. You suppose that's the team?
Yeah.
That looks like pretty promising. I see another bus there.
you guys, and then if you guys want to kill 40 minutes right now, go tune into the TCM pod on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Music. Go tune in. 40-minute show this week. Go watch it.
Or, you know, you could just sit here and listen to us.
No.
I think it'd be more exciting listening to you and Spence, you and Chris talking about sports. So that is the TCM, the Chris Mathis podcast. It's on YouTube. It's on Spotify. Anywhere you get your podcasts that you listen to. Is it, so it's a video podcast?
Video and audio, yes.
Okay, so either one. You could listen to it driving down the road, watch it on your YouTube. That is pretty cool. And you guys just talk about various sports things?
All sports. Mostly football, though. Mostly football.
Are y'all just both really good football critics? Or?
Yeah. Well, Chris thinks he's a good football critic, but I know he's listening right now. He's not. I think I'm better than him in every way possible, every conceivable way that your mind takes you right now. I'm probably better than Chris. So if he's listening right now, I just want him to know that.
Oh, that sounds like a challenge. Yeah. I think that's a brother challenge right there. I wonder if Chris is sending us messages here. Let's see. Oh, I said hello to the famous Chris Mathis of Florida radio fame, and he writes back, I'm honored to be here watching this game with you and all your other high school football fans tonight. Thank you, sir.
The cheerleaders are selling 50-50 jackpot tickets at the top of the steps.
Did you see players getting off? I didn't.
I did not.
I'm not sure that was. Again, we are in a delay here as the Union County Panthers football team has not yet arrived to the Banks County field after they were caught behind an accident on the way. They were not involved in an accident, but they were behind an accident somewhere between here and there, closer to here, I believe. So now that Chris has moved on, and you're doing this local radio jig here, what is your outlook on the future here? What do you have down the line?
It's going to be awesome.
That's a fairly generic answer, but I mean, are you looking to stay in the industry or?
Yeah. We're looking to stay in the industry. Not around these parts, most likely though.
Going to Florida?
Probably relocate somewhere.
Okay. And if people like to listen to you, they can also listen to you over at the PBC Sports Network with the Mountain Lion Sports Network doing broadcast work over there with Young Harris College, the Mountain Lions. And you are on there sometimes with who all are you on there with?
I'm on there with Tommy Jenkins, Coach Krieger. Just two absolute stud announcers. Also, if you go to a Young Harris College basketball game, I'll be the PA guy this year, taking over that one guy that used to do it. I forgot his name. He's related to me, but I can't quite remember his first name. So I'm taking over his job. So just come in, support Young Harris College athletics if you don't want to watch Union County tonight.
Well, you can watch this game tonight, and then you can watch Young Harris tomorrow, because we'll be there tomorrow, right? Me and you both, Lord willing.
Women's soccer at noon, men's soccer at 3.
Yeah, that's going to be quite a challenge for us to get out of here at Banks County, drive home, and then be set up for 12 noon tomorrow. But that's where we'll be, Lord willing.
Yeah, we might get out of here hopefully around 1 a.m. The game's supposed to start at 12, so we got to be there around 11. So we'll see how it goes.
Should be fun.
So who are they playing tomorrow? Do you? No clue. Yeah, I haven't looked at the schedule that close, but
I know the men are playing Lander, if I remember correctly.
Well, you can look that up at YHCAthletics.com, and you get the lowdown on all the Mountain Lions sports and scores and schedules, and see who the coaches are. We've got some new coaches this year. I bet one of the basketball coaches, the assistant coaches, and of course I don't remember his name, but I met him the other day, and he seemed like a really nice guy.
Nice. I need to introduce myself to them. We'll see how it goes, but I'm working on it. We're working up to it.
Yeah, that's going to be coming up reasonably soon, mid-November.
Well, yeah. The purple and white game is October 31st, Halloween night.
And that's like an intramural squad or however
you... it's all Mountain Lion players playing each other.
Right. So you can come out and get a kind of a preview of how they're going to do. Mm-hmm. Come out and enjoy that on, again, Halloween night? Is that
Halloween night. Halloween night.
And that would be on a Monday, I'm pretty sure.
Yes.
Unfortunately, I'm working that night, and I will not be able to get to see all the goblins and ghouls on the square in Blairsville or anywhere else.
That's sad.
That is sad. I actually like to see that. I like to see the kids dressed up, all their costumes, and their moms and dads dress up too.
Yeah. And also, a former Banks County Leopard is going to be playing in that game. Carl Cleveland goes to Young Harris, very good basketball player. He's starting on the men's team this year. Should be fun to watch.
Right, and Carl Cleveland's father is the athletic director here at Banks County High School. I haven't seen him tonight, but...
I have not either, but he did a great job getting us set up here tonight. He supplied this table for us.
Yeah, we've got a nice location overlooking the field. It's a lovely night out here. The moon is almost full looking up here.
The lights are flashing over there.
Yeah.
Someone signaling help.
What is that? That's kind of a weird looking. That must be over at some other field there. That is rather bizarre. But this is a nice facility. They have a nice school here. Really modern. I mean, everything. It's nice looking new. Looks like I wonder what they're doing here on the end zone here. I imagine they're building a field house of some sort. There's some construction work on the, I think that probably is the eastern end of the field or so.
I have no sense of direction.
Well, I usually figure that the sun sets in the west, so I kind of, you know, I go by that. But, you know, relatively eastern side.
What about on opposite day?
Opposite day? I don't know.
Sets in the east on opposite day.
Perhaps. But it looks like maybe they're doing some construction work there, and I would guess maybe a field house of some sort, although they have one at the other end. So maybe it's like a visitor field house, or maybe they're putting in more seating for the crowds. I don't know.
A ton of Union County fans showing up now, awaiting the team, before the team. And then also, if you look to the right of the stands, you can see a yellow bumblebee-type sheriff car for Banks County, which is pretty cool.
Is that? That's the sheriff's car?
Yeah.
And that looks like a Camaro of some sort.
It is. It is a Camaro. It's Bumblebee. It's a Transformer.
All righty. That's pretty cool looking.
Yeah.
That's nice. I noticed one of their other cars was sitting up here.
Could I have your attention, please?
It looked pretty nice.
Would all the flag football and tackle football players go down to the left of the field, down to the left down here?
I think they should have the flag football players, these young flag football players, maybe play a game in front of us.
They should maybe do a quarter of play just to see how they're doing. Just to entertain the crowd. Well, as they say, Banks County does have a lot of their younger flag football players lining up. They have some, looks like some younger cheerleaders. lined up. I guess they're going to have some recognition going on.
Tonight's game is being brought to you by Tencati Salt Max. Thank you for your sponsorship to Banks County Athletics. We'd also like to thank Metro Site, ALGC Grading, Anthony C. Bolt Baking, the Sunbeam Bread Man, and Bo Garrison and David and Katie's Amish Store. We appreciate your continued support of Banks County football.
Amish.
You think they have an Amish football team anywhere?
I don't know if they've heard about football yet.
Yeah, I think that's not in their but I wonder if they actually do any kind of sports. I mean,
they probably do compete in professional butter churning.
Professional barn building.
Yeah.
Who can build the fastest
barn building and barn burning?
I don't know about barn burning, but
maybe.
I have visited the Amish country, and it's a really nice area.
I've never visited the Amish. I have a fear of Amish, the community.
Well, they kind of have a fear of us, so
it's a back and forth.
I like the Mennonites a little better. Yeah. They're a lot friendlier.
I like the malcontents.
I actually ran into some Mennonites. This is a really interesting story. I was, or maybe not, but to me it is. I was... I was traveling, and I was somewhere near, maybe it was in Alabama, near where they have, like, some NASA installations, and they had, like, a visitor center that had a bunch of NASA stuff with rockets and this kind of stuff. And so I just pulled in and was looking around, and there was an a Mennonite family. They were looking at it, and I thought, well, that's really kind of odd. But they were really – I talked to them a while, and they were really friendly folks.
Nice.
And they were interested really in that. And, you know, there are some Mennonite communities in southern Georgia, middle and southern Georgia. And just an interesting way of life.
Yeah. And my lead PR guy, he told me to watch my comments about the Amish, but I don't think they're listening right now. So I think I should be fine.
Well, I don't think the Amish Mafia is going to get after you.
I hope not. Unless they found technology over the past 12 hours.
Probably not.
But I will keep silent. Thank you, PR Chris Mathis.
So Chris has been...
He shut me off.
Shut you off, yeah. On that, on the Amish... Well, it is a beautiful night for football. If we had the other football team here, we'd be playing some football. Unfortunately, Union County has been delayed. They got behind some sort of accident on the way here, and were delayed quite a bit. And I guess we're still awaiting them to show up. They're on the way, though, we understand. Here we are in Homer, Georgia. Have you ever been to Homer?
I have.
It's an interesting little tiny town.
Yeah. They've got a nice little mile-long strip of stuff, and then nothing. But it beats Blairsville in terms of stuff.
Well, you know, Blairsville's Blairsville. And
true.
Every town has an interesting, something yes. neat and interesting about it. Like, except for Cornelia, and, you know, what can you say about Habersham County?
Oh, they've got a casino.
Murphy has a casino, and they have a pretty nice downtown area. I will say that. Blue Ridge is nice downtown, you know, by the train. That's a pretty cool train thing. Towns County has got some scenic areas.
Vehicle is pulling up. Not the team.
Not the team.
Looks to be a black SUV.
Men in black have arrived.
Blackout wheels. So We've got some cool notes. Chris Mathis wants you to check the live stream comments on YouTube.
Explosive Shane. I don't know who that is. Chris Mathis says, big fan of the owner of Ridgeline TV, Mr. Moon, and of course my brother Spencer is on the call tonight. And he says, have you heard of the Chris Mathis podcast? Yep, we were talking about the Chris Mathis podcast. Yep. Where Chris and Spence talk a lot about football and sporting events and questionable plays, I suppose.
Yes.
All of those things. I think Chris and Explosive Shane they're having a go back and forth. I don't know who Explosive Shane is, but uh-oh. Here? Oh.
Here they come.
Oh. It's just the junior Leopards running across the field. Some excitement. I think this is the youth league little football players. They're running down the field. Nice. And just so everybody knows, I am not going to be commentating tonight. I'm going to be on the camera, so you won't have to put up with me much longer.
It's getting chilly.
Yeah, you know, it was really warm when we got here, and, you know, the sun's gone down, and it's kind of a nice little sunset out there to the west.
On the TCM pod, we also do interviews. Ralston Drake, a Union County now legend, just finished hiking the Appalachian Trail a couple days ago, and we're going to have him on the show on Tuesday. So that'll be interesting. He completed it in less than 6 months, which is better than average. So Ralston Drake, his new term is better than average. But he's a legend.
Yeah, he's a legend. He's been posting about every day on Facebook
and YouTube.
His progress and a little bit of commentary about what he's observed, what he's seen, how hard it's been. And he really, it's been kind of interesting watching that every single day, see where he's at, where he's, the problems he's had to face. But he's hit Mount Katahdin, and if I'm saying that correctly, probably not.
In exactly 162 days.
162 days. Yeah. So I'm sure he's back home now.
Yep.
Probably has been for several days. And you guys had him on the podcast. Well, that's great.
We will have him on the podcast. It will air on Tuesday.
The Tuesday podcast, the TCM
pod.
The TCM podcast? Is that
just TCM underscore pod.
TCM underscore pod. Okay, and that is... And looky here. It looks like the Union County Panthers have finally arrived on two buses. Unless that's the band.
I think the band's already here.
The band's already, I see the band is already here. Good, good. So this would have to be the football players.
Or it could be another school system's buses. We don't.
They might have gotten lost. And you know, I have a story about that. One time when I worked at the newspaper, I went to cover Union County football playing, Jackson County, I guess.
Yeah.
And you realize that Jackson County has, like, how many different school systems?
Yeah, they have a ton. They have East Jackson, probably West Jackson, maybe South Jackson, maybe even North Jackson.
Well, and then the Commerce City Schools and Jefferson City Schools. And I showed up at the wrong stadium, and I was walking in looking around like, man, I don't know any of these people. And I mean, I'm looking around like, before I went in, I was like, asked the girl at the ticket counter, like, who's playing tonight?
Yeah.
And it was not us.
Not us.
So had to backtrack and go right down the road, but that was before we had Google Maps and all those electronic devices to help us around there.
Yes, that is the football team. That is now football squad of Union County.
Very good to go, and they're gonna have to go to the locker room, I'm sure, and get their uniforms on, get some warm-up time. Do you know how much they warm up?
Once the first couple of players get onto the field, they're going to give them 25 minutes of warm-up time.
25 minutes of warm-up time after they get on the field. And as you see, looking at the field right now, you can see the youth football for Banks County, the little Leopards, or the junior Leopards. I'm not sure what they call them, but they're pretty cool. They're on the field. The little cheerleaders are running around with their pom-pons, and they're kind of playing some football, I think, tag football themselves, so that's pretty
the
cool.
Buses just now arrived for Union County. They're getting out of the buses now and heading over the locker room.
Looks like we've got some really good talent out there.
Okay, so whenever they put on the clock. I have no clue at the moment. I can text Isaac Pugh and figure it out, but they just now are entering the locker room.
Okay, thank you. Union County has just arrived. The game will start at 8:15. The game will start at 8:15, so we got about 30 more minutes before we get kicked off here.
Yeah.
As you heard there, 8:15 will be kickoff time.
You texted it to me a couple weeks ago.
So about a 45-minute delay we've had here as the Panthers were delayed by a traffic accident. Not involving them, but they were on the road and got caught in a accident. And we certainly hope all those folks were okay. Someone suggested that there was a fatality in that accident, and that is what held the traffic up so long. So we certainly want to remember all those folks that might be related and involved there. But of course, we don't know that for sure. So.
Hey, Garland. This is Spencer. Do you have the countdown going at the moment? Okay. What is it at right now?
No, don't worry about it.
Okay. Could you?
All right. We're still looking at about a half an hour until the game starts. About 8:15 will be kickoff. The players just arrived a couple of minutes ago. And we'll be going to the locker room, getting their uniforms on, and about 25 minutes or so of warm-up time there. So we will be having football tonight, but a little bit of delay here.
pregame's going to start at 7:55.
7:55 pregame show will begin on the radio station WJRB 95.1 FM.
FM. 95.1 FM.
Mr. Spencer Mathis will be on the call.
I hear a ton of like audio through here right now.
Let me check.
Is that the
this.
Mic? The field mic?
Sorry. Sorry.
What are you hearing?
I don't know exactly.
Hello? Testing 1, 2, 3.
I can hear you, but it's very loud.
Well, just turn your earphones down there. Yeah, don't mess with that too much. Just use that if you want to.
Okay. I'll turn this down.
That's your headphone setting. But are you hearing that too loud?
Yeah, it's this. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, that's...
What do you think that is? The return?
Yeah.
Is that better?
I guess. I don't know. That sounds awful loud there. It sounds... Sounds like it's coming into your...
This, do you think? That would be 3. That'd be this one.
Wow. God. No, it's not that. It's like it's coming into that, coming in really hot on this right here. Can you talk to...
He should be able to hear you through there, right through there.
Garland, can you hear me? Garland. Garland Johnson. Jefferson, whatever your name is. I can't hear him.
Garland, can you hear us? Garland.
Is it... Garland?
I'm going to call Jeff.
It's like really, like
yeah,
it's super,
loud. Super loud.
I mean, you didn't, it's not coming out way loud here, is it? It's like. Hello, hello, hello.
Hey, Jeff. We're having the same issue with the headphones where it's just really loud. What did we do last time? So I really can't hear anything besides the headphones. Is that 3?
Yeah, I don't think it was that.
Okay, I did.
So I don't hear anything on. I don't hear any crowd. You get it turned down. So.
Okay.
But it's like going into that.
I'm on 2. Okay.
I can't hear anything coming through.
Now he can't. Now he says he can't hear anything coming through, John.
Garland, Garland. Garland. I don't hear anything coming through.
Okay.
Is this thing on? It doesn't appear to be on, is it?
I'm on 2.
Is this supposed to be? Are you sure that's plugged up?
Yeah, I gotta connect back to the station to figure this out, though. Right now the Shure is off because I'm not connected to the station, so.
Oh, well, so then you're probably hearing.
I think that should do it though. I muted the field mic and I muted headset 1. Okay. All right. Thank you.
If this thing's not on, you're probably just hearing the
yeah.
mic on this.
All right.
So hook up to the station and see if it's. I think you're just hearing it through your microphone here.
There we go.
Let's see what you want.
Is it better?
Yeah. Garland,
can you hear us? Garland Johnson. Checking Garland 1, 2, 3. Garland 1, 2, 3.
Garland. It's awful loud, but you can turn the return down, right?
Yeah. Is that better?
No, but I can't hear him.
Yeah, I cannot hear Garland.
Turn that down just a little bit.
Okay.
Garland, can you hear us?
Garland, testing Garland. Can you hear us? I'm going to call a station.
What is happening? Do you need my phone to call instead of doing that?
Yeah.
And if you want to keep that going. And
oh.
Can you type in the number?
Yeah, why is this so loud? Why is that so loud?
What is it, 706?
379-9770.
John Moon, here's Spence. Hello.
Hey, Garland. Okay, we cannot hear you. Yeah.
Okay, so what should I do here?
Okay, sorry about that. I think you've been hearing a little bit of our background chatter, trying to get the radio feed working there. Having a little trouble with that. Apologies there, but you get to hear what goes on behind the scenes when we're freaking out. We have had a delay here. The players only got here about 10 to 15 minutes ago. They were delayed in behind a traffic accident. So it's going to be about 8:15 before we kick off. Hopefully the pregame show on the radio will kick off a little bit earlier than that. Spencer is working through some technical issues and trying to get stuff working. We're having trouble with the return from the station so he can hear when he hits a break there.
Our team will be coming out onto the field for warm-ups, and as soon as they exit the field, we'll be doing our national anthem. So after the teams exit the field, we'll be doing our national anthem, getting ready to start the game. Thanks.
All right. Just heard from the public announce dresser there, public address announcer, if I can say that correctly. A little bit about what's going on here.
So text me whenever we go into commercial break. Can you text me right now to check and see if that works? Okay. bus coming to the stadium was late to arrive by about 2 hours. They were caught behind a crash. They got here about 15 minutes ago. The game is set to start here at 8:15 here in Georgia. A big game coming up for both of these teams. The first region game for Union County so far this season. So we'll see how Union County will fare. But right now we're going to go to the commercial break here on 95.WJRB, and we'll be right back in 60 seconds.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Panthers are warming up. Finally got here, having quite a bit of a delay here as the Panther football bus was behind an accident and was delayed quite a bit. They're warming up right now, and we hope to have the game. I think they're saying that it'll be kicking off about 8:15.
Working on the technical difficulties at the moment, trying to turn the game down here in Banks County, Homer, Georgia. We've got a lot of technical problems in this game, only because this game started off so late. We're trying to figure that out before kickoff. I'm sure we will. We've got about 10 minutes and 40 seconds, but within 40 seconds, we're going to go to that Michael Perry interview with Jeff Batten. A great interview from the Union County Panthers head coach, a team that's 4-1, so much better than they were last year. Have already exceeded last year's win total, and they're 4-1 through five games. So Jeff Batten had a chance to sit down with Michael Perry. We're going to send you to that interview now. Whenever we return, we're going to preface the beginning of this game. But right now, tune in to this interview between Jeff Batten and the head coach for the Union County Panthers, Michael Perry.
Been a couple of weeks since we checked in with Michael Perry, the head coach of the Union County Panthers, but we're glad to have him on the line now as we look back to a 48-7 victory over West Hall a couple of weeks ago, and the Panthers now looking pretty good at 4-1. Michael, I know that it's been a couple of weeks. What were your recollections of the game, and did you walk off the field thinking that you were pretty happy with the effort all the way around?
The best I felt was about our offensive line. Those guys are continuing to just get better and better every week. That really showed, because we were able to have a big night. Raider and both Connor Shutnick had a big night running the football. So just really proud of those guys. Defense has been playing great all year. So yeah, it was a nice night. Seems like forever ago. Now we're ready for Banks County tonight.
4-1 as we have the Leopards in our sights up near Homer, Georgia. We'll get to that ball game in just a second. Now you talked about your two running back tandem of Connor and Braylon. Have you got a strategy right now about who you use in what situation, whether it's a tough yard that you need or whether it's a power sweep that you need? How are you looking at those two guys?
So I consider both those guys power runners, definitely, for sure. And really, it's just whoever's got the hot hand. That's it, how we ride it. Both guys, we're lucky to have both of them. And we play the hot hand, and both of them get plenty of opportunities. And if someone starts doing something really spectacular, we just ride the big boy and until he's tired and put the other one in.
Let's talk about wide receivers. Jensen has had a great year so far. Talk about the other guys that you feel like that you have a lot of confidence in, that if you had to get a third and five on a quick slant, they'd be the guys to do it.
Griffin Young, he's been a spark for us all year. He's had a great year for us. Tyler Grassi, really proud of him. He stepped up. He's really stepped up at our tight end position and gotten better and better. He's really mature for how young he is. So really proud of him. And then Zach Taylor, I mean, him and Ethan McBride at our X position, I mean, have done a really good job, specifically in the blocking game. Zach Taylor's a really good blocker. And, you know, Ethan helps us so much out in the kicking game, obviously, as well.
Talking with Michael Perry as we get ready for Banks County and look to go 5-1. And that five wins would be a couple more than you got all of last year. I know that we've talked in the past, Michael, about how much better you think this team's, this version is than over last year. Are the kids believing it now? Can you see a difference in the way that they conduct themselves, not even just on the field, on the practice field, but even in the locker room, the way that they're looking at the season?
It's funny because Banks does a lot of different things. They haven't played a lot of teams like us that really throw the ball a lot. So we had to go back and watch last year's game, and our kids are watching that. And, I mean, the kids are like, man, God, we are so much better than we were last year. So I think it's evident. Everybody sees it, knows it, more confident as the weeks go by.
So you like your offensive line. You like your defensive line. I think you like your linebacker core okay. I know that you said that there was a question mark on the secondary. Are you feeling like that all 11 guys are giving you the most of what you could expect?
Definitely. Speaking of the secondary specifically, I'll tell you what, Sam Page, he is probably the most improved football player on our team. He's also the young man that had that game-saving tackle against Fannin County week one. But I couldn't be prouder of Sam and how he continues to get better. Such a hard worker. He comes to work every day, practice every day, and brings his best. Wilson Walker's another one. Wilson, such a great kid. Big help in our special teams game, too. But just real physical, really sets the tone back there.
You had a key injury with one of the guys that's been getting a lot of minutes on defense. That's Taylor Whitehead. Does it look optimistic that he might be able to rejoin the team in time for the playoffs? Because I know he's had some nice moments so far this year.
Yeah, we're really proud of how much he's grown. And corner is definitely, you're on an island most of the game, so you have to have a quick memory. But he has just gotten so much better as a football player. We're still waiting. We're not sure we'll get him back before playoffs. We sure do hope we can, because he's definitely been a spark for us at corner. Hopefully we'll get Brain Plott back here soon, who will be a big help to our defense as well. He's been hurt all year, so hopefully we'll get him back. So that's the one plus of these 2 weeks, is the ability of getting some of our guys who are banged up, injured, back.
Absolutely. And last question, in order to make the playoffs, we've got to start winning region games, and that starts tonight with Banks County. Tell me what you're looking at, Michael.
Oh, we've harped about everything we've done before this. Doesn't matter at all. Because, you know, region obviously dictates where you are in the playoff standings. We're going to do everything we can to secure a home playoff bid. Banks was kind of upset, I would say, last week by East Jackson. So Banks is...
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years. For over 30 years, Carter Insurance and Investments has provided the Union County area with quality and competitive products for life, health, and disability insurance, as well as Medicare supplements. As an investment advisor representative, Carter Insurance and Investments can help you build an investment plan that's best for your financial situation. To learn more, stop by and meet our friendly staff. We're located on Young Harris Street across from the post office in Blairsville. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli, providing the best quality of meats in the area, located between Young Harris and Blairsville. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Union County Farm Bureau, proud sponsor of Union County football and the Georgia High School Association.
Yeah, I don't know if we're back on yet, Garland. Actually, no, let's not try that. He's just going to text me to turn up gain or audio. Can you call Garland again and ask him if we're on air yet? I mean, and the national anthem here in Homer, Georgia has just concluded. We've got 2 minutes left on the clock before this game is ready to kick off. It is going to be an absolute barn burner, I'm telling you right now. Union County just sat on the bus for 4 hours in this before this game started. So they're gonna have to work out the kinks at the start of this game. Banks County is a good football squad, 4-2. Union County's 4-1 on the season. This should be a great one. And this is the first time that we've seen Union County play a region game. We've already mentioned this a couple of times, but it is going to be a great game. And then right now we're going to keep it here, though, because at halftime we will show off the interviews that I had with Caden Tanner. I got a chance to sit down with Caden Tanner, the starting quarterback for the Union County Panthers, and also one of their star linebackers out of the three linebackers, Gage Barnes. So this is going to be a great one. We've got about 1 minute and 30 seconds. Don't know if they're going to add another 3 minutes like they usually do before the kickoff. We'll see. The teams are getting set to run through the banners now, though. The cheerleaders are rolling out the banners. The band got here about an hour ago. Union County band was here around 7 p.m., but the Union County football team showed up about 35 minutes ago. They've had some time. The captains are walking to midfield right now. The captains for Banks County, I see number 55, Eli Ward. Number 5 for the Leopards, Shane Roberts. And number 28 as well. On the roster, they've got him listed as Andrew Shockley, but he wears number 14. Union County Panthers captains are across the field, walking over to the Banks County logo right now in midfield. They've put another 3:15 on the clock. Union County Panthers captains are number 0, Wilson Walker. Number 14, Sam Page. 35-gauge Barnes, and the fourth captain for Union County, number 67, Noah Helton, the great offensive lineman. And that has been a big point of emphasis for Union County this season. The offensive line started off basically a pretty new unit on the offensive line. Hadn't worked together more than a year, but they have really got it going over the past couple of games. Over the past three games, Union County's had at least one 100-yard rusher. Braylon Raiders really picked it up for Union County. He'll be wearing number 34, the B train for Union County.
Our captain tonight, number 5, Shane Roberts. Number 28, Kellen.
Getting ready to do the coin flip at midfield. Number 28 is Kelton Wally. He swapped numbers with Andrew Shockley on the depth chart. So
Andrew Shockley.
Coin toss coming up for Union County. PA address announcer here at Banks County has done a great job keeping the fans ready for this game, even though it's going to be about an hour late start. This game is supposed to go at 7:30. 45 minutes isn't too bad of a delay. Could have been much worse. Our hearts go out to the family of the victims of the car crash that stalled this game by about 45 minutes. Hopefully everyone involved is okay. We don't know reports on it yet. The initial reports were that there was a fatality in that crash. So hopefully everyone else involved was okay. 12 minutes is gone on the board here in Homer, Georgia. Still waiting for the coin toss. And Banks County will defer to Union County. So the captains will run back behind their banner here in Homer, Georgia. Union County with a nice banner that the cheerleaders put together as usual. A big Panther on the purple banner for Union County. Then Banks County also has a gigantic banner. It says Banks County Leopards, and the Banks County Leopards are getting ready to run through that right now. We'll turn the field mic up for that. Union County Panthers band plays, and here come the Union County Panthers. Running to midfield at the moment, Union County trying to get under their legs at the moment. Here come the Banks County Leopards as well as their fans cheer them on here in Homer, Georgia. Led by number 62 for the Banks County Leopards and Andrew Humphreys. Humphreys, a junior offensive lineman / defensive lineman for the Leopards. So Union County should receive here first. I think Banks County deferred. And they're going to send Union County back deep to return at the moment. Back deep to return for Union County. Number 12, of course, is going to be Jensen Goble along with looks to be their captain, Wilson Walker. A great safety for Union County and on to kick for Banks County. Number 56 and Iron Lopez. So Lopez is about to put toe to leather here in Homer, Georgia. Time at 8:17 p.m. Once again, back deep to return is Jensen Goble and Wilson Walker as the kick from Iron Lopez is going to go out of bounds. So Union County is going to have great starting field position to start this one. And let's see how this offense will start off for Union County. Of course, led by Caden Tanner in a great rushing attack that includes Braylon Raider and Connor Shucknick. Connor Shucknick has really picked it up. He had a great game a couple of weeks ago against West Hall before the bye week.
You have a concession stand on your side of the field along with restrooms. If you need any assistance while you're here, please see one of our administrators.
So the Union County Panthers offense comes onto the field right now. They'll be starting from their own 35-yard line. Tight end, of course, Tyler Grasty. He'll be to the left with a couple of receivers for Union County. Jensen Goble among those names. Also, Zach Taylor lined up to the left. Tanner ready to take the snap. A sidecar to his right is Braylon Raider. Banks County with four down linemen. A quick screen pass to Zach Taylor. He's going to pick up about 3 yards. But a great gang tackle there by Banks County, led by number 48 and Kaz Oliver. A gain of just 2 yards for Union County on the first play. So Zach Taylor, the Panthers receiver, has 3 touchdowns on the season. That nears him to about 100 yards on the season. He's got about 98 now on the season after a 2-yard catch. Sidecar to Tanner's right is Shucknick. Braylon Rader comes up to the line. Shucknick takes a handoff, and he's going to pick up about 7 or 8 yards. That's going to bring up 3rd down and 2 for Union County. So an early 3rd down. And that was actually Griffin Young lined up in the backfield for Union County playing running back, with Braylon Rader kind of playing in a tight end offset position along with Grasty. A blocking tight end and Rader. And the handoff once more goes to Griff Young, and he's going to pick up a Union County 1st down. The pile still moving past midfield. And the forward momentum, the forward progress has stopped at the Banks County Leopards' 49-yard line. Nice piece of running so far for the Panthers. That was Griffin Young. Usually split out wide as a receiver, but he's been in the backfield the entire game so far. Now they've got 2 running backs with Braylon Rader to Tanner's right and Griff Young to the left. Tanner takes a snap. That's Jensen Goble in motion. Goble takes the catch, and he'll pick up about 5 yards. Shoved out of bounds. A nice tackle there made by number 22 of the Banks County Leopards and Aussie Jacobs, their sophomore defensive back/receiver. A gain of about 5 for Jensen Goble. Couple of quick dump-off passes for Union County and some inside zone runs. They are at the Banks County Leopards' 44-yard line. Taylor split out wide to the left for Union County. Tanner takes a snap, a quick little dump off to Braylon Rader running along the far sideline. He's going to pick up about 3 yards, and a 3rd and 2 coming up for Union County once more. 1 for 1 so far on 3rd down conversions.
Shockley makes a stop.
Tackle made by Andrew Shockley, the Banks County Leopards star running back. And they're going to send Brody Stafford onto the field, their linebacker, a freshman. Here for the Leopards, a quick handoff to Braylon Rader. I don't know if he's going to get the 1st down. He's picked up about 1 yard, maybe back to the line of scrimmage. A yard gain is going to bring up 4th down for Union County. So now 1 for 2, but Union County this season has played basically every 4 downs to go. They haven't punted the ball very often. They've gone for it in short situations, even in field goal range for a 25-yard field goal. We've seen them go for it. So here on 4th and 2, they're not going to be shy. They're going to go for it. Wilson Walker will be lined up to the right of Caden Tanner again. Braylon Rader in motion to block. Tanner takes the snap. Hand off to Griffin Young, and he is going to be stuffed in the backfield by number 72 of the Banks County Leopards, Robert Walker. Huge play made there by the Banks County Leopards defense, and they get the Union County Panthers offense off the field on the first drive, and the Leopards take over on offense. Great defensive stop there for the Banks County Leopards. So the Leopards offense comes onto the field. Quarterback looks to be number 10, Colby Watson. Usually on Max Preps, they had Kane Griffith listed as the starting quarterback, a senior. He had 3 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. First play is going to be a quick handoff and a pretty nice gain for the Banks County Leopards down to midfield, a gain of 7. That was Ozzie Jacobs taking the handoff.
Wilson Walker makes a stop.
Tackle made by Wilson Walker, who we just saw lined up at running back a little bit in this one. So maybe Connor Shucknick not ready to go just yet in this game. Usually the number 2 running back. They were using Braylon Rader in a new type of tight end formation. An extra blocking tight end. He was doing a great job, just couldn't get the 1st down on 4th and 2. Man in motion for the Leopards. 3 receivers split to the left and a tight end lined up. Leopards take the snap, and he's going to be stopped in the backfield immediately. He's back to the line of scrimmage, and making the tackle there was Lane Lance, and he has been an absolute terror for Union County so far. He has been great. And this is going to bring up an early 3rd down for the Leopards. No 1st downs yet, but just 3rd and 3. Leopards huddled up. They break the huddle. Ball sitting inside their own 50, just inside the 50. Andrew Shockley is lined up at quarterback, a wildcat formation. He takes a snap, And he's going to look for the first down, but I don't think he's going to get it unless he breaks five tackles, and he does not. Union County with a huge stop on third down, and that's going to bring up fourth down and six.
Loss of yards on the down. Gage Barnes makes the stop.
And we'll see if Banks County wants to also be aggressive here on the first drive. Union County was it. They got bit by their decision. They tried to do a quick inside zone handoff to their receiver slash running back in Griff Young, who has been an absolute weapon so far for Union County this season, but they did not pick up the first down. So Banks County is going to go for it as well from inside their own 50. And no, they're going to do a punt, a very, very close to the line punt there. Great punt by the Banks County punter. That's number 22, Aussie Jacobs. And that ball is going to be down inside the 10-yard line. Union County is going to start first and 10 from the 7. And Union County's offense, we're into the field. So both teams so far in this game have failed a fourth down. Of course, Union County went for it on fourth and 2, didn't get it. Banks County with a nice piece of punting there from inside their own 50 all the way down to the Panthers, to their own 7-yard line. So Union County is going to be backed up. They're going to have to go 93 yards if they want a touchdown. And they've still yet to attempt the field goal. That's not an extra point this season. So Union County plays every down four, all the way down to the four downs. I mean, they have really not kicked field goals this season. They punted it a couple of times. They've got a great punter in Wilson Walker. Three receivers to the left for Union County. Tanner takes a snap, looking for a quick bubble screen to Jensen Gobley. Gets the pass completed to the 5, to 15, to the 17-yard line. He's pushed forward all the way down to the 20. A huge gain of 13 yards on the first play of the drive for Union County. Tanner's pass was completed to Jensen Goble. The Panthers have looked short so far this game. Tanner is a great deep ball passer, and I think the Banks County Leopards defense knows that. Tanner takes the snap, another quick pass to Jensen Goble along the far sideline. He's going to pick up a first down, a gain of 12.
Shane Roberts on the stop for the Leopards.
Tackle made for Banks County by Shane Roberts. 7 minutes left here in the first quarter of play. Panthers snap it quickly, a quick pass to the right side. That is going to be Griff Young, and I think he's got enough for the first down again. So three plays, three first downs on this Union County Panthers drive. Shane Roberts again making a stop. Union County ready to snap the ball. They might catch Banks County lacking with an extra man on the field. They do not. Tanner takes a snap. He'll keep it, rolls out to the left, and a little bit of an overthrow intended for Jensen Goble. A play-action pass with a boot rollout to the left on a play-action, and the pass just a little bit over Jensen Goble's head on the bubble screen. That's going to bring up second down and 10. And we've got a stoppage here with a Banks County Leopard down at the 45-yard line. That's going to be number 22, Aussie Jacobs. He's made a couple of tackles so far in this game, was trying to come off before that last play was snapped. And now he's on the ground, so they're going to have an injury timeout. But it's going to be a quick one as Aussie Jacobs gets back up. Fans clap for Jacobs as he makes his way over to the sideline under his own power. Union County huddled up at their own 40-yard line. Second down and 10 will be the next play from their own 44. As the Banks County Leopards defense comes back on. Number 72, Robert Walker, a very big defensive tackle.
Tonight's game is being brought to you by 10 colleagues. 10 colleagues.
The Panthers break the huddle. 6:38 left here in the first quarter. Panthers defense, Panthers offense lined up ready to go. So are the Leopards on the defensive side of the ball. Tanner takes the snap. A quick handoff to Braylon Rader to the right side. He's going to pick up 6 yards, and that'll bring up second down and about 5. They'll give him 5 down to the 49-yard line.
Braylon Rader on the carry. Andrew Shockley.
And the tackle was made by number 28, Andrew Shockley. Leopards defense trying to get off the field here. They do in time. Jensen Goble will come into the backfield alongside Rader. A third down and about 5 for Union County. Zach Taylor split up very far to the left. Cornerback playing about 6 yards off might have an opportunity here. Tanner's looking over to the sideline. He'll relay the message to his two running backs in Goble and Raider. Tanner takes the snap. Both running backs go up for a pass. Tanner's complete. No, it's dropped. The pass was open. A good play call there for that third down and about five. But Zach Taylor can't hold on, and that's going to bring up fourth down for Union County. And near midfield, they're going to bring out the punt team. So the Union County Panthers punter Wilson Walker is out there. And back deep to return for Banks County, Andrew Shockley. Walker's punt from his own 40-yard line is an absolute boot down to the 10. It's going to bounce past the 10-yard line. It's going to be down inside the 10. So both teams with great punts to start this game. Union County now two drives where they couldn't really get anything going. Banks County's defense has played great so far in this one, and a good punt by Wilson Walker is going to make the Leopards start their second drive of the game at their 7-yard line. They'll be huddled up here around the 25. 5:51 to go in the first quarter of play. Getting a bit more chilly here in Homer, Georgia. Time at 8:30. Game started around 8:17. We're about 12 minutes in, 5:50 to go in the first quarter. Quarterback once again for the Leopards is Colby Watson. Watson will take the snap here. Quick handoff to the right side and a nice piece of running by Andrew Shockley. He's going to pick up about nine, maybe enough for the first down.
Colby Watson hands the football off to Andrew Shockley. Wilson Walker makes the stop.
Tackle made by Wilson Walker. And Banks County, not a quick tempo team, so they'll huddle up again. That'll be just enough for the first, actually no, just short of the first down. It's going to bring up second down and inches for the Leopards. Union County defense in white tops, purple pants, and Banks County in all blue with pink socks for Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Another quick handoff to Shockley, trying to bounce it to the outside. And he'll be tackled around the line of scrimmage. May not be enough for a first down again.
Shockley takes the handoff. First down, Leopards.
And that'll be enough for a first down for the Leopards. Tackle made by Gage Barnes. A nice run by Andrew Shockley on second and inches. So first and 10 now for the Banks County Leopards at their own 16-yard line. Watson takes the snap, another quick handoff this time to the right side. Shockley making a couple of juke moves, but he's going to pick up about two.
Shockley takes the handoff.
Nice job by the Panthers safety Wilson Walker coming up to make the tackle. Playing in the box on that play. It's going to bring up second down and 10.
Give him a yard pickup.
Once again, thank you for tuning in here on 95.1 WJRB, the voice of the Union County Panthers. This game, of course, with a late start, we've had a couple of technical difficulties, but thank you for sticking around and also watching it if you're on YouTube on Ridgeline TV. As a quick handoff again to Shockley, this time he's going to be stopped for no gain. It's going to bring up third down and 9. They're going to huddle up here, third and 9 coming up. As the quarterback Watson makes his way from back over from the near sideline. Still scoreless here with 3:30 to go in the first quarter of play. Shockley lined up beside Watson. Two receivers split out wide to the left, one to the right with a tight end offset. Watson takes a snap. It's a play action boot rollout to the left. And the pass is going to be intended for number 4, Caden Watson, but it falls incomplete, and that's going to bring up fourth down. A flag is down at the 10-yard line, usually in the area of holding. We'll see what the official call is here. But a couple of handoffs to Andrew Shockley. That time they tried to catch the Panthers with a play-action pass. Union County was ready. And and it was holding against Banks County. And that play, that penalty, of course, declined. So fourth down and nine, Banks County have most likely going to punt from inside their own 20-yard line. Fourth and nine from the 18. Punter for Banks County, Aussie Jacobs. They line up very close to the line of scrimmage here, the punter does. Usually most teams have them back about 10 yards. Banks County has them back about 7. Jacobs takes a snap, a punt, and that one takes a horrible bounce off of his leg. That punt is actually going to go for negative yards. A negative yard punt for Aussie Jacobs. The punt, the fourth down play was snapped from the 18-yard line. Union County is going to start from the Banks County Leopards 16. And they've got to capitalize here. That's very unfortunate for Banks County, but Union County's got to take advantage here with 2:22 to go in the first quarter of play. The Union County's offense makes its way onto the field. If you're a Union County Panthers fan, you've seen Cole Wright, the former Union County Panther quarterback, a great quarterback. He once punted for about 5 yards. That time, that's probably one of the worst I've seen. That one goes for -2, but Aussie Jacobs has had a great game for the Banks County Leopards. Tanner takes a snap, a quick handoff to Braylon Rader up the middle. No one's there. He's going to truck his way down to the 5 inside the 2. And Braylon Rader is into the end zone for a touchdown. A great piece of running by Braylon Rader, and the B train is into the end zone for Union County. His 8th rushing touchdown of the season. He's really picked it up over the last 3 games, and he's going to take it here into Homer, Georgia. A 16-yard touchdown run for Braylon Rader in Union County with a 6-0 lead with 2:11 to go in the first quarter of play. Rader made it about 10 yards before he was even touched. Union County's offensive line with great blocking on that play. On to kick the extra point, Ethan McBride trying to make it 7-0 Union County Panthers. McBride's extra point is up, and it is good. Union County with a 7-0 lead with 2 minutes to go in the first quarter of play. We'll be back in 60 seconds here on 95.1 WJRB.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years. For over 30 years, Carter Insurance and Investments has provided the Union County area with quality and competitive products for life, health, and disability insurance, as well as Medicare supplements. As an investment advisor representative, Carter Insurance and Investments can help you build an investment plan that's best for your financial situation. To learn more, stop by and meet our friendly staff. We're located on Young Harris Street across from the post office in Blairsville. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli, providing the best quality of meats in the area. Located between Young Harris and Blairsville. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Union County Farm Bureau, proud sponsor of Union County football and the Georgia High School Association.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB to broadcast you this game between the Union County Panthers and the Banks County Leopards. A fair catch called for at the 29-yard line for the Leopards. They'll start their third offensive drive. Union County just needed one play on their previous drive, a 16-yard touchdown run from Braylon Rader. And Union County's up 7-0, a nice kickoff there by Zuriel Mancias. Banks County's offense trying to get something going. Shockley's had a couple of good runs, but other than that, Banks County has kind of been stifled by this Union County Panthers defense. Panthers linebacking core coming to play today. Also safety Wilson Walker with a couple of tackles early on in this game. Nolan Thompson, the cornerback closest to us on the near side of the field. Leopards with a running back to the right side is Shockley, a tight end offset of the formation. Watson takes a snap, looking deep. And a great pass to Andrew Shockley, and he is going to race past some Union County Panthers defenders. And that is going to be a 70-yard touchdown pass by Colby Watson to Andrew Shockley, their star running back right there, with a great route, and he showed off his speed. A touchdown for the Leopards. So both teams match each other with one play touchdown drives. But Bakes County, a 70-yard touchdown pass from Watson. And Union County just could not keep up with the speed there of Andrew Shockley. And Bakes County looking to tie this game up at 7. On to kick the extra point is Iram Lopez. Lopez's extra point is up, and it is good. We are tied here at 7 in Homer, Georgia. Union County Panthers tied with the Bakes County Leopards. We'll be back in 60 seconds on 95.1 WJRB.
For years, your source for sales, parts, accessories, and service for golf carts has been North Georgia Golf Carts. Now they're at a new, more convenient location. Owner Rick Goddard and staff are there to assist you with all your golf cart needs. They sell and service all types of golf carts, from Easy Go to Club Car to Yamaha. And they provide pickup and delivery for any service work. That's North Georgia Golf Carts, now located east of Young Harris near the intersection of U.S. Highway 76 and State Highway 17 North.
Get your prescriptions filled in minutes at Brasstown Pharmacy Drug and Gun in Blairsville. Flu shots, the PCR COVID test, regular COVID test, or antibody test today. Brasstown Pharmacy is your go-to pharmacy for curbside pickup, personalized compounded medications, and more. And we're loaded with a full line of firearms, ammo, and gifts. Brasstown Pharmacy Drug and Gun is the best bang for your buck behind McDonald's in Blairsville. Call or text 706-745-2303.
Back here on 95.1 WJRB, Union County Panthers had a 7-0 lead for about 13 seconds, and then Andrew Shockley had a 70-yard touchdown for the Leopards, and he has a ton of speed. Union County, of course, had him X'd out on this coming into this game. Shockley at now over 1,400 total yards on the season through just 6 games and a quarter. I mean, this kid's had an incredible season. Here comes the kickoff from Iram Lopez. And back to return for Union County is Wilson Walker. He'll take it down to the 30, to the 35, down to the 40-yard line, making a juke back inside. He's all the way down to the 48-yard line. A great return there by Wilson Walker, and Union County will have plus field position to start. Beautiful kickoff return for Union. And the tackle made by Kaz Oliver. So Union County starting off first and 10 from the 50-yard line at midfield. Both teams with back-to-back one-play touchdown drives. Raider for the Panthers and Shockley for the Bakes County Leopards. Both of those guys coming into this game were probably the number one player to watch for both of these defenses. Tanner with a sidecar to his left. He'll take the snap. A quick handoff to Braylon Raider. He's going to pick up about 5. And he averages 6.2 yards a carry, and he's done the same thing tonight. He's had a couple of good runs in this one, including that 16-yard touchdown run. That was Griffin Young on the kickoff return for Union County. Union County once again in all white with gold outline lettering. Tanner takes a snap, a quick pass out wide to the right side, and that's going to pick up a first down for Union County.
Griffin Young on the carry.
Griffin Young with the catch there for Union County. Once again, that was Griffin Young on the kickoff return, not Wilson Walker, number 6 for Union County. Panthers will have one receiver to the right, two to the left, with a sidecar and Braylon Raider to Tanner's right. No tight end lined up on set. Tanner takes a snap, a quick handoff to Raider, and the Bakes County defensive line right there wins the battle. Braylon Raider gets forward progress about to the line of scrimmage, so second down and 10 coming up for Union Raider County. And the Bakes County Leopards defensive line has played a pretty good game. Other than that 16-yard touchdown run, they've kept Union County's running backs at bay. Panthers now at the Bakes County Leopards 40-yard line, second down and 10. Just over 30 seconds left to play here in the first quarter. Tanner with an empty backfield will take the snap, rolling to the right under duress. A design screen. The pass is going to be completed, and that's going to pick up a first down. A couple of juke moves. He's down to the 20-yard line, and they're still fighting down to the 15. Forward progress has not stopped down to the 11-yard line. A huge reception there for Union County, and that should be the final play of the first quarter unless they want to get one more off. Griffin Young is having a great game for Union County. He's touched the ball a lot so far in this one through the first 12 minutes of play. 13 seconds to go in the first quarter. They may get one more playoff in the first. Clock winding down from 8 seconds. Tanner takes the snap. A quick design screen to the right side. That's Jensen Goble. Will cut back inside. He's going to pick up about 5 yards, and that'll do it for the first quarter of play. Union County tied at 7 with the Bakes County Leopards. here in Homer, Georgia. We'll be back in 60 seconds on 95.1 WJRB.
For years, Bitter Creek Market has been the best little market in the mountains. Now they're even bigger and better with additional room for specialty foods, vegetables, and frozen foods. But don't worry, Bitter Creek Market still has the best selection of quality meats in the area. Their professional butchers prepare the best cuts of meats daily right on site, and Bitter Creek Market grinds their own sausage using only quality cuts of meat. For the gourmet cook, Bitter Creek Market has a wide selection of high-quality food items. And don't forget Bitter Creek Market's deli. Stop by for freshly made sub sandwiches and pork barbecue smoked right on site. They even have homemade potato salad. And they have picnic tables by the creek for your dining convenience. Bitter Creek Market is open Monday through Saturday. Come by and see the friendly staff today. Bitter Creek Market. The best little market in the mountains.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB. Union County Panthers with great field position to start the second quarter of play, tied at 7, a pretty neck-and-neck football game thus far. Both offenses picking it up a little bit over the past couple of 5 minutes or so. Union County will officially have the ball first down and 10 at the Banks County Leopards' 8-yard line to start off the second quarter of play. Once again, we want to thank our sponsor, Union General Hospital / Union General Health System, here for bringing you this broadcast of Union County Panthers football on 95.1 WJRB and also Ridgeline TV. So the first play, the second quarter, two receivers to the left for Union County. That's Zach Taylor and Jensen Goble, with number 6, Griff Young, line up to the right side. Braylon Rader in the backfield. Both teams awaiting the first snap of the first quarter. The refs are having a bit of, having a quick conversation here with the pylon holders, with the chain gang, as they move their way closer to the end zone here. It'll be second down and 5 for Union County. Officially, the first down marker is at about the 3-yard line. Union County's at the 8. They need 5 yards here to pick up the first, but they're going to be looking for a touchdown. Rader lined up to Tanner's right. And there's going to be a pre-snap penalty here, and it's going to be against Banks County. An offside penalty against Banks County, and that's going to bring up a very short second down for Union County. Referee's still looking to see where he wants to move the ball up to. So Union County will have it about second down and 1 at the 4-yard line. Penalty on the first play of the second quarter here. Rader still lined up, and I'm sure he's going to be getting the ball here first. Second down and 2, handoff to Rader, and he is going to be stood up by Banks County. A great play there by the Banks County defensive line, along with their linebacker number 48, Kaz Oliver. And Oliver's been all over the place for Banks County in this game. His name's been called a lot in this one by the PA announcer here in Homer, Georgia. And a great play by Kaz Oliver is going to bring up a third down and 3 for Union County, a loss of a yard officially. In the backfield now for Union County is going to be number 6, Griff Young. Rader in motion along the line. Tanner takes a snap. It's a quarterback draw, and Tanner's into the end zone for a Union County Panthers touchdown. And Union County will go up 13-7 over the Banks County Leopards. A quarterback draw on third down and 3. A great play call there by the Union County Panthers. Banks County caught off guard with Braylon Rader coming in motion. A couple of times we've seen that where they've handed it off to Griff Young. Instead, that time Tanner takes it himself, and Union County with a 13-7 lead on the third play of the second quarter. Ethan McBride's on to kick the extra point for Union County. McBride's extra point is up, and it is good. Union County with a 14-7 lead with 11:14 to go in the first half of play here on 95.1 WJRB.
Union County Panther football broadcast brought to you by Carter Insurance and Investments in Blairsville. Serving the area for over 30 years. Best of luck to the Panthers.
When you combine quality products, excellent customer service, and the best prices in the area, the result is Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing.
In business since 1963, Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing has served the surrounding area with a variety of home improvement supplies. Everything from vinyl siding in many colors, trim pieces, shutters, soffits, vents, and accessories. Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing, located west of Blairsville on Highway 515.
Union County Football is brought to you by Joyce S. Kemp, DMD, providing family and cosmetic dentistry to the Blairsville area. Best of luck, Purple Swarm. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by North Georgia Golf Carts, providing a full range of sales, accessories, service, and parts.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB. Union County Panthers now with a 14-7 lead over the Leopards. Last time they had the lead, they held it for 13 seconds before a 70-yard touchdown reception by Andrew Shockley right there. We just saw a Caden Tanner quarterback draw from the 4-yard line, in which he got into the end zone, and Union County's up by 7. The kickoff here coming from Zuriel Mancias. It's going to bounce at the 20-yard line. Banks County will return it. Andrew Shockley from his own 12. And he's going to be stopped around the 14-yard line. They're going to mark him at the 14, about a return of 2 yards for Banks County. A couple of score updates from around Georgia high school football. Andrews is up over Swain County, 21-0 at halftime. Fannin tied at 0 with Modell at halftime as well. So two score updates brought to you by Garland Johnson. Thank you, Garland, over there at the radio station at 95.1 WJRB in Young Harris. So Banks County looking to match the Panthers' touchdown, which they did on their previous offensive drive. They are going to start in the Wildcat formation with Andrew Shockley looking to take the snap here on first and 10 from their own 15-yard line. Shockley takes the snap. He's looking to throw. He's throwing it deep. And it is going to be dropped by number 16 of Banks County. That's Zach Dickey. A pretty good throw there from Andrew Shockley, a running back for Banks County. Coverage for Union County, number one, a new face for Union County's defensive backs. That's Daniel McPhee. And head coach Michael Perry was looking forward to getting to see him play this season. And there, that one was just a drop pass by number 16, Zach Dickey. Would have been a gain of about 20 yards for the Banks County Leopards. Instead, it's an incomplete pass. It's going to bring up second down and 10. Quick handoff to the left side to Shockley. Ducks under a tackle, and he's going to pick up about 3 yards. It'll bring up third down and 7 for the Banks County Leopards. Once again, we want to thank Mike Cleveland, the father of Carl Cleveland, for getting us this table set up here in Homer, Georgia at the Banks County High School Football Stadium. Hooked us up with good positioning for John Moon, our cameraman. But there's going to be an injury timeout here for Banks County. A player is down on the field. So we're going to take a quick break here on 95.1 WJRB. Union County Panthers lead 14-7 over the Banks County Leopards.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing in Blairsville, proud sponsors of the Union County Panthers.
If you've got a nagging sports injury, then Union General Orthopedics and Sports Medicine is ready to get you back on the field. Dr. Jacob Sturton, Dr. Ronald McBeth, and physician assistants Brian Haas and David Zollinger are currently accepting new patients at their office. They can help with everything from a sports injury to knee or shoulder pain. If you want to get back to living and being active, call Union General Orthopedics and Sports Medicine at 706-439-6858.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Leon's Floors, located in Blairsville, offering sales and installation of carpet, vinyl, hardwood, and tile flooring. Union County football is brought to you by the North Georgia News, providing news and sports coverage to Union County for over 100 years. Go Panthers!
Back here on 95.1 WJRB, as the third down play for Banks County does not end up going in the Leopards' way, it's going to be a loss of 5 yards. Cooper Ashcraft in the backfield immediately, and it's going to bring up fourth down at about 13 for the Leopards, and a big punt coming up for Banks County. The last punt went for negative 1 yard. Under 10 minutes to go in the first half of play, Union County up 14-7. With the return man back deep is number 12, Jensen Goble. This time a much better punt for Banks County. Goble fields it around the 40-yard line, down to the 30, to the 30, to the 26-yard line. A nice return by Jensen Goble and a good tackle by Banks County at the 26-yard line. That's where Union County will start this drive after back-to-back touchdown drives. Looking to keep it going here. Another score update from Garland Johnson. Andrews is up 27-0 over Swain in the third quarter. So Andrews is having a great season, and they're continuing it. The Panthers starting first and 10 from their own, from the Banks County Leopards 26-yard line. Two receivers to the left with Grasty, the tight end. A quick handoff. No, it's a play-action pass from Tanner. He's looking deep into the end zone. He's got a man, and he's got a touchdown for Union County. A 26-yard touchdown pass from Caden Tanner, the first time he's looked deep in this game, and it's completed. And Union County leads 20-7. A beautiful throw by Caden Tanner there into the end zone to number 88, Zach Taylor, now with four touchdowns on the season receiving. So three touchdown drives in a row for the Panthers, and Taylor now has just as many touchdowns as Jensen Goble does receiving on the year, both of them with four apiece. Usually not the man they look for deep down the field, but Zach Taylor had his guy burnt. And Union County has a chance to go up 21-7, barring this extra point from Ethan McBride. Another quick touchdown drive for Union County. The extra point is up, and it is good. Union County up by 14 with 9:13 to go in the first half of play here in Homer, Georgia.
Locally owned since 1980, Leon's Flooring is your full-service flooring store with the largest showroom in the area, guaranteed to save you money with over 50 years of total sales experience. The folks at Leon's Flooring are experts in ceramic tile, carpet, hardwoods, and vinyl. Located at 568 Murphy Highway in Blairsville, next to the Mexican restaurant and across from Mike's Seafood. Leon's Flooring, call them today at 706-745-9433. Oh, and by the way, say hello to Diesel while you're there.
Check out North Georgia Water Sports in Blairsville for all of your watercraft wants and needs. Offering inventory loaded with new and used watercraft, including Avalon, Tahoe, Tracker, and Sun Tracker boats. Whatever you want, they got. North Georgia Water Sports also offers a service department with highly trained technicians during all business hours. Don't forget to winterize your boat at North Georgia Water Sports. Call 706-835-1222. Visit NorthGeorgiaWaterSports.com or stop by 2132 Murphy Highway in Blairsville.
Back here on 95.1 WJRB as Zuriel Mancias kicks it off to the Banks County Leopards. They field it at the 31-yard line. They've got to go 69 yards on this drive. Union County with three touchdown drives in a row, the last one being a 30-yard touchdown pass from Caden Tanner to Zach Taylor, who has four touchdowns on the season and now over 100 yards receiving. So the Panthers offense has picked it up, and so has the defense. Just that 170-yard play has been really the big thing for Banks County in this game. But other than that, Union County's done a great job. Banks County will start first and 10. They're going to mark them at their own 31-yard line. Of course, their quarterback being number 10, Colby Watson, with Andrew Shockley lined up to his left. Two receivers to the right and one to the left. And a pre-snap penalty here, and that's going to be against Union County. Offsides on Union County is going to bring up first and five for Banks County. So both teams get set for the first play of this drive. A quick handoff to the right side to Andrew Shockley, trying to outrace a defender. He does. He gets the edge. Can he get back to the line of scrimmage is the question. Union County is swarming, and Andrew Shockley is going to be dropped for a loss of about two. He really did everything he could there, try to get the outside edge, but the blocking was not there for Banks County, and Union County gets a tackle by number 10, Nolan Thompson. A loss of five on the play is going to bring up second down and 10. So the pre-snap penalty on the play prior doesn't really matter as much anymore. Nice tackle by Nolan Thompson. He's done a great job at cornerback in space for Union County since week one. He's done great at tackling. In that Fannin County game, he had a huge tackle in week one. But other than that, he's had a great season for Union County in his first year as a cornerback. Another quick handoff to Shockley. And he's going to get back to the line of scrimmage. That's going to bring up third down and nine for Union County, for Banks County. Another good tackle for the Panthers, and Shockley has nowhere to run in this game. The Panthers linebacking core is playing great. We've seen Cooper Ashcraft and Gage Barnes both make some splash plays early on in this game. Both of those guys with over 40 tackles on the season. Barnes with 50 tackles, 13 tackles for loss, and three sacks. And then you also have Cooper Ashcraft, four sacks and 43 tackles on the season. So they're a great linebacking core. Andrew Shockley is a great running back, and it brings up third down and seven for Banks County. They've been stopped a couple of times in a row, and Union County has been pouring it on. They're up by 14, 21-7 Union County lead. 7:38 to go in the first half. Watson rolling out to the right under duress. Lane Lance pursuing him, and that's going to be a throwaway forced by the Panthers' defensive line. Lane Lance leading the way, and that's going to bring up fourth down and seven for Banks County, and we'll see the punt squad once more probably, unless they really want to risk it here from inside their own 40-yard line. Fourth down and seven from their own 34, down by 14 with 7:28 to go in the first half of play. Quarterback Colby Watson making the right decision there, trying to throw that one away on third down. And it looks like this is going to be a punt, and on to punt for the Leopards, number 22, Aussie Jacobs. Jacobs punt, this time another good punt from Jacobs as Goble's going to watch that one bounce inside the 40, and it's going to be down at the 37-yard line out of bounds, and that's where Union County will take over. Up by 14 points over Banks County. The offense has really picked it up. The defense, of course, for Union County is always great. A deep shot on the last drive for Union County. Caden Tanner's first of the game ends in a Zach Taylor 30-yard touchdown reception. To recap the touchdown so far for Union County, we had a Braylon Raider 16-yard touchdown run on the third drive of the game to put up Union 7-0. Then we had a Caden Tanner 4-yard touchdown run on a QB draw. And following that, a Zach Taylor touchdown reception for 30 yards. So Union County's up by 14 points. As Andrew Shockley is really the main key factor for Banks County. They just haven't been able to get him going. They've got a wildcat formation here on first down. The Panthers are going to pick up about 3 yards. There's a flag thrown in the backfield.
Number 64, Levi Johnson.
Tackle made there by number 64, Levi Johnson, a very big defensive tackle for Banks County. And we have a roster correction here. Daniel McPhee is listed as number one on the Union County Panthers roster, but this is actually the first time that we've seen Cade Dockery start at cornerback for Union County. This is his cornerback debut. He's had a pretty good game so far. He's made a couple of tackles. So Cade Dockery, usually wearing number 16, he's going to be wearing number one today, and his first start as the ex-cornerback for Union County, according to Chris Mathis and Paul McBride. They've in practice this week, they had Jensen Goble line up against Cade Dockery, and Dockery did a great job. He's earned the starting spot for Union County due to the injuries that they've had in the backfield. Taylor Whitehead being one of the key injuries for Union County. Hopefully he makes his way back onto the field this season. A pretty big injury a couple of weeks ago versus West Hall, but Cade Dockery's in for Union County. Tanner takes a snap, looking deep along the middle. He's got a first down, and that is going to be a catch made at the 15-yard line by Jensen Goble. And he'll make his way inside the 15, down to the 13. A huge gain for Union County. Caden Tanner with another beautiful deep pass. And Tanner, Caden Tanner, the Panthers' starting quarterback, has a great deep ball, and he showed it off all season right there looking across the middle. And a timeout's going to be taken here by Banks County, looking to regain their legs here. So we're going to take a quick 60-second break on 95.1 WJRB, the home of the Union County Panthers.
Constantly challenging ourselves as a college means more learning opportunities, better teaching, more innovative programs, greener facilities, a stronger community, and happier students. Every choice we've made reinforces our mission to help educate, inspire, and empower you. Young Harris College, this is the place where your future unfolds.
Spry Family Dry Cleaners in Blairsville specializes in deep cleaning and efficiency. Not only do they take the basics, but they also work with rugs, comforters, draperies, and other household items. Now featuring a drive-thru for contactless pickup and drop-off. Not to mention a wash-dry and fold service. Drop it off. When you pick it up, it'll be folded, sorted, and bagged. Spry Family Dry Cleaners, cleaning up our community, one garment at a time. Located in Blairsville at 46 Hunt Martin Street, across from Cochran Funeral Home.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB as Caden Tanner races his way into the end zone for Union County. The Panthers didn't get the 60 seconds that Banks County would have allotted on that timeout. Caden Tanner with a QB keeper takes it to the far sideline and a touchdown for Union County, diving for the pylon, a highlight play for Union County. And they lead by 20 with 6:35 to go. They are pouring it on right now versus Banks County. Two touchdown runs by Caden Tanner, the first two of the season for him. Usually a pocket passer for Union County. He's now got 11 touchdowns on the season. So 6:35 to go in the first half of play. Union County looking to make it a 21-point lead with the extra point coming from Ethan McBride. Extra point is up, the rush coming, and it is good once more by McBride. Union County is up by 21 points with 6:35 to go in the first half of play here on 95.1 WJRB.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by the Family Medical Practice of Thomas Karisny, MD, in Blairsville, serving Union County and the Mountain area. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli. Providing the best quality of meats in the area. Located between Young Harris and Blairsville.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB as Zuriel Mancias kicks it off once more, and it's going to be fair caught at the 31-yard line by Humphreys. And that's where Banks County's offense will take over. Down now by 21 points, four straight touchdowns for Union County Panthers offense. They have really poured it on here as of recent, but Banks County trying to stay in it here from their own 31 on this drive. Andrew Shockley has done really all he's been able, all he's given the opportunity to do in this game. I mean, they've handed it off to him. He has had no space. He's broken a couple of tackles. He's made a couple of defenders miss, but other than that, he hasn't been able to get anything going because the blocking here for Banks County has not been the greatest in this game. But first and 10 from their own 34-yard line is where the Leopards will start. A quick handoff to Shockley. He's going to try and cut it back inside, but the Panthers defense swarms again. The ball is out, but I think they called forward progress down. I heard a whistle whenever Shockley made his way back to the line of scrimmage. The ball was stripped away. But they're going to call him down at the 34-yard line. Gage Barnes makes a tackle that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Leopards. Referees there quick to blow the whistle. As Banks County makes its way back to the line of scrimmage here with number 10, Colby Watson, leading the way. Once again, the ex-cornerback for Union County is Cade Dockery, making his Union County Panthers debut at defensive back. We've seen him take a couple of snaps at quarterback this season. A quick handoff to Andrew Shockley. He's going to pick up two, and that'll bring up about third down and 8 for Banks County. And Shockley has really nowhere to go right now behind this Leopards offensive line. The Union County Panthers defensive linebackers and defensive line are absolutely swarming right now. Gage Barnes alongside Cooper Ashcraft and Elijah Helton have all played great games. Clock winding down to about 5 minutes remaining, just over 5 minutes remaining in the first half of play. A third down and 8 is what Banks County is faced with. It'll be number 22 in the backfield, Aussie Jacobs. We've seen him punt a couple of times. A third down and 7 is what they're going to call it officially. Union County Panthers with three down linemen trying to get after it. They bring a blitz. It's a direct snap to Andrew Shockley. He's going to pick up about 8 yards. And that's going to bring up fourth down and 1 from the 43-yard line. A huge decision coming up for Banks County. They've really got to go for it here. Tackle made by Wilson Walker on the direct snap to the running back Shockley. Fourth and 1 from inside their own 50, but they've got to go for it here. Down by 21 points. As the Banks County Leopards come up to the line, Union County Panthers kind of looking at a pump formation. We'll see they're really crowding the line here on fourth down, and a timeout taken by Union County just in case, a smart timeout taken. We're going to keep it here on this broadcast, though, here in Homer, Georgia. Once again, we want to thank Union General Hospital for sponsoring this game and helping us broadcast you this on 95.1 WJRB and also on Ridgeline TV. You can tune into that and watch the game on YouTube if you're feeling like it. So once again, coming into this game, Banks County was on a two-game losing streak. They started the season off 4-0, and then they lost 17-14, a close battle versus Commerce. And then last week against East Jackson, they lost by about 31 points. So that one was a tough game, their first region game. This is their second. They're trying to keep it close here against Union County, but the Panthers have really, really came on strong as of recent. With 4:16 to go in the first half of play, Banks County is faced with the biggest play of the game thus far, a 4th-and-1 from inside their own 50-yard line, actually inside their own 45-yard line. Another score update from the Andrews-Swain game. Andrews is leading now 33-0 over Swain in the third quarter. They are absolutely pouring it on again, and Andrews is having a great season. They've really turned that program around here as of recent. A direct snap to Shockley is going to pick up the first down for the Leopards. A nice run on the direct snap, and that's really the only time they've been able to get anything going is if they get the ball in Shockley's hands. He is their offense, and right there he makes a huge play for Banks County. A big first down run there on 4th-and-1 from Shockley, a gain of about 4. They'll still be inside their own 50-yard line. Clock now under 4 minutes remaining in the first half of play, as the quarterback Colby Watson makes his way back onto the field. Starting quarterback before this game was Kane Griffith, who had 3 touchdowns and 4 interceptions on the season, 405 passing yards. But tonight they've got Colby Watson taking the snaps as the field general for the Banks County Leopards. Watson takes the snap, a nice little play, a quick handoff to the receiver coming in motion, but he's going to be stifled for no gain. A great play there by the Panthers defensive line. That was number 6 for the Leopards in Lane Morris, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd down and 10 coming up for Banks County. Every yard has been tough to come by besides that 70-yard touchdown catch by Andrew Shockley on the running back angle route. Time winding down fast here in the first half of play. Luckily for Banks County, they get the ball to start off the second half, so a touchdown here would be absolutely huge for Banks County's chances of winning this game. They'd only be within 14. They'd get ball to start the second half. And here before the snap, we've got a timeout taken by Banks County. So we're going to take a quick 60-second break here on 95.1 WJRB. Union County leads 28-7 over the Banks County Leopards.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Union County Farm Bureau, proud sponsor of Union County football and the Georgia High School Association.
For years, your source for sales, parts, accessories, and service for golf carts has been North Georgia Golf Carts. Now they're at a new, more convenient location. Owner Rick Goddard and staff are there to assist you with all your golf cart needs. They sell and service all types of golf carts, from Easy Go to Club Car to Yamaha. And they provide pickup and delivery for any service work. That's North Georgia Golf Carts, now located east of Young Harris near the intersection of U.S. Highway 76 and State Highway 17 North.
Union County Panther football broadcast brought to you by Carter Insurance and Investments in Blairsville, serving the area for over 30 years. Best of luck to the Panthers. Union County football is brought to you by Joyce S. Kemp, DMD, providing family and cosmetic dentistry to the Blairsville area. Best of luck, Purple Swarm.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB. During the break, a quick handoff to Andrew Shockley for a gain of about 4 yards brings up a 3rd down and 6 for the Banks County Leopards. Tackle made by number 28, Elijah Helton, for the Union County Panthers, one of the 3 linebackers for the Panthers. The cornerbacks for Union County have not really been tested in this game. We've seen Sam Page playing the deep safety position along with Cade Dockery as the ex-outside cornerback, but they have not really had to face a lot of throws in this game, and that's what we expected coming in, but they faced a lot less than probably expected with this different quarterback starting the game. And Colby Watson over Kane Griffith. Watson takes a snap. The receiver falls down. That was intended for Andrew Shockley. And the cornerback also slipped along with him. So that's going to be an incomplete pass, and that's going to bring up 4th down and 6 for Banks County with 2:06 to go in the first half of play. They're inside the Panthers' 50-yard line on 4th and 6. They went for the 4th and 1 last time on a on a designed quarterback wildcat draw to Andrew Shockley. This time, fourth and six. That play is really not in the cards here. Nobody lined up on number 11, the receiver for the Leopards, and Colin Caudell. But it looks like Banks County is going to punt here on fourth down. And this time it'll be Andrew Shockley, and he boots that one. It's going to bounce from the five, and it will – I don't think it touched the end line. That punt is going to be down at the one-yard line. A beautiful punt by Andrew Shockley. As good of a punt as you can have. The running back for Banks County with an amazing punt for them. And the Panthers start within their own one-yard line. They've got to go 99 yards in a minute and 52 seconds, and they've really got to worry about the safety here. Banks County, I'm sure, is going to be wanting to bring the blitz here. I don't know if Union County is going to want to throw out of this or they're going to try and run out of it with the B-train and Braylon Rader. But the Panthers' defense comes up big once more. They gave up one fourth down, but that time Banks County decided to punt it away. They still kept the threat of going for it there on that fourth down with Andrew Shockley taking the snap on the punt. But a beautiful punt by Shockley. The Panthers first and 10 from their own one-yard line as Caden Tanner's back deep. Nobody in the backfield with him. Tries to draw off the Banks County Leopards, and I think he does successfully. An offside penalty against Banks County. That's going to put the Panthers up 5 yards. They'll be first and 10 from their own 6-yard line. That's a huge cadence there by Caden Tanner. And a first and 5 will be the result of that. Once again, under 2 minutes remaining here in the first half of play on 95.1 WJRB. Union County up by 21 points. As the Panthers offense is going to converge here, they're going to put Braylon Rader back into the backfield. First and 5. Rader with that one touchdown run, but other than that, they have not ran the ball very much with Braylon Rader. We've seen 2 touchdown runs by Caden Tanner, his first 2 of the season. But here we're going to see it looks like a timeout by Union County. So we'll take a quick 60-second break, and we'll be back in 60 on 95.1 WJRB.
For over 30 years, Carter Insurance and Investments has provided the Union County area with quality and competitive products for life, health, and disability insurance, as well as Medicare supplements. As an investment advisor representative, Carter Insurance and Investments can help you build an investment plan that's best for your financial situation. To learn more, stop by and meet our friendly staff. We're located on Young Harris Street across from the post office in Blairsville.
Check out Sunrise Grocery in Blairsville, not only the oldest business in Union County. Sunrise Grocery was also named the most charming general store in the South by Southern Living Magazine. Swing by and snag some world-famous peanuts, local produce, and goods, not to mention Jason's highly sought-after photography and Jessica's homemade soaps and candles. That's Sunrise Grocery in Blairsville at 7568 Gainesville Highway, 706-745-5877.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB as the Panthers took a deep chance there to number 6, Wilson Walker, and he was tackled by the Banks County quarterback, the Leopard wearing number 5, Shane Roberts. A flag was thrown by the back judge. We'll see what the call is going to be. Obviously, look like pass interference from here, but you never know. You can use it. But the pass was intended for Griffin Young. A nice throw there by Caden Tanner, but the cornerback tackled Griff Young as the refs converge around the 10-yard line. And 1 minute and 46 seconds left here in the first half of play. A couple of score updates from Chris Mathis. Fannin trails the Blue Devils 10-0. Aquinas leads Towns County 35-0. And Murphy over Hayesville 14-7 in the third quarter of that game. So those score updates from Garland Johnson and Chris Mathis, both of them working diligently to bring you those scores as I read them out loud from their text. But Union County facing a first and 5. We'll see what the official call is after that incomplete pass. Maybe a pass interference as the refs converge here to make the call. We'll see. Maybe they call holding on the Leopards defensive back. They're going to stay with pass interference. There were actually 2 fouls on the play committed by Banks County, and it's going to bring up a first down either way, whichever one they accept for Union County, as the chain game makes its way up all the way from the 6-yard line. The head referee is going to place the Panthers ball at the 21-yard line. So a 15-yard penalty there by the Banks County Leopards. So Union County with a minute 46 to work with. They've now only have to travel about 80 yards in a minute 46. They do not kick field goals this season. We've always seen extra points out of Ethan McBride. So we'll see what the cards hold for Union County here. First and 10, Braylon Rader lined up in the backfield. Two receivers to the right side. Jensen Goble playing in the slot. Braylon Rader in the backfield alongside Caden Tanner. Banks County showing blitz. A handoff to Braylon Rader. He's going to take it up the middle. Slips and falls, a gain of about 5 for Union County. Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 30-yard line. Clock still winding down, a minute 30 to go here in the first half of play. This time two receivers to the left along with a tight end and one to the right end, Zach Taylor. Tanner takes the snap, looking left, and he's going to find Jensen Goble, and that's going to be a first down for Union County. Fighting down to the 47-yard line, a great throw there by Tanner. Tanner has been very accurate in this game, and he's had time to throw it all night. The Union County Panthers offensive line has held up their end of the bargain once more. That was actually Tyler Grasty, the tight end, making the catch there. A nice catch by Grasty, a gain of about 25. They're going to have it first down and 10 at their own 48-yard line. A minute 7 to go in the first half of play. The Panthers' offense is moving quickly. Of course, the clock stops after every first down. Griff Young lined up to the far side, near side actually, with two receivers to the right. Tanner takes a snap, a play-action pass, looking over the middle, and he's going to be brought down. A sack coming from Banks County. And that was number 48, Kaz Oliver, who continues his reign of terror. Kaz Oliver's had an incredible first half for Banks County. And that's the first time either quarterback has been sacked in this game. That time it's Kaz Oliver getting the sack for the Leopards. Clock winding now down under 40 seconds to go in the first half of play. Panthers moving a bit slower than usual. Second down and about 20. Tanner takes the snap. Looking for a screen pass. It's going to be picked off by number 48, Kaz Oliver. And the tackle's going to be made by Caden Tanner. But with 21 seconds to go in the first half of play, the Banks County Leopards offense will take over. An interception thrown on the screen pass intended for Braylon Rader. And Oliver, after a sack, gets an interception. Back-to-back splash plays by Kaz Oliver. And the Leopards have 21 seconds to score here. And the flags may move them even closer to the end zone. May have been a flag on the tackle by Caden Tanner. We'll see what the official call is here. 21.3 seconds to go in the first half of play. They're going to need to put up some type of points here before the end of the first half, but they've got a good opportunity now. Referee sorting it out around the 20-yard line. So right there, just a screen pass, and Banks County brought the blitz. I don't think Tanner saw Kaz Oliver drop back into coverage against the running back for Union County, and Oliver picked it off. Just his third turnover of the season. Referees huddled up here. A couple of flags thrown on the field. Three flags all placed at the 25-yard line. Still trying to hash things out. Leopards ready to go on the offensive side of the ball. 21.3 to go. If the flags don't do anything, Banks County will start at the Panthers' 19-yard line. Following the Kaz Oliver interception. And it looks like a player was disqualified. The refs' mics are not hot. You can't hear them throughout the stadium, but from John Moon's zoom in, it looked like he said he was ejected. The foul is actually against the Banks County Leopards after the Oliver interception. And they're going to be moved back further away from the Union County end zone. 21.3 seconds to go in the first half of play. They've got to put some points on the board. Not sure the ability that their kicker has in Irem Lopez. Had a couple of nice kickoffs in this game, but not sure how that translates to actual field goals. And that's a 15-yard penalty, so Banks County starts first and 10 at the Panthers' 34-yard line. Not exactly who was the culprit of the penalty for Banks County, but it looked like he said he was ejected. Saw him give the throw-out motion as the referee makes its way over to the Banks County sidelines to talk to the head coach. Banks County head coach, of course, Jay Reed, their assistant offensive coordinator slash head coach is Vince Latosky. So he'll try and get this group ready to go, trying to put some points on the board. They've been stuffed ever since that 70-yard touchdown by Andrew Shockley. The referee is still talking with the head coach. Both teams still huddled up. Union County defense ready to go, but the Banks County offense still talking with their offensive coordinator. As the referee tries to explain to the Banks County head coach Jay Reed just exactly what the reasoning behind the ejection was. Two referees now there trying to explain to him. If you're watching here on Ridgeline TV. Panthers defense ready to go, though. Sam Page chatting with Cade Dockery and Seth Rutan, or Nolan Thompson. Stopping the flow of the play a little bit here at the end of the first half. So it was a blindside block against Banks County. And he was disqualified. Couldn't exactly see the number of the culprit. So the player was ejected. Couldn't see the number of who it was, but a tough penalty to take for the Leopards after an interception by Kaz Oliver. Offense for Banks County still huddled up there. And the offense is finally going to make its way back onto the field, led by their quarterback number 10, Colby Watson. Good thing for Banks County is that their star running back wasn't the culprit of the play. Andrew Shockley is still on the field, so he's been their main piece in this game, that 70-yard touchdown to show for it. It's 28-7 Union County, but they've got a good chance here at the end of the first half. They also get ball to start the second half, so points here would be huge. They're going to go in a gun-empty formation here. Three receivers to the left, one to the right with a tight end. Watson takes the snap under immediate pressure, and he's going to have to throw that ball away with his left hand. And he took a pretty big hit there at the Banks County midfield logo by Gage Barnes, and there's going to be a penalty on the field. And they're going to call roughing the passer or intentional grounding on Banks County. Thought maybe they would get Elijah Helton for a late hit. Instead, it's an intentional grounding as Watson, as soon as he got the ball in his hands, he was chased by Gage Barnes and their defensive tackle, Elijah Haynes. Really nothing he could do with that. It's going to be intentional grounding on Banks County. 16 seconds left here in the first half. The final 5 minutes of this first half have really slowed down the pace of this game. Banks County now at their own 45-yard line. I mean, if there would have been no blindside block by Banks County, they would have been inside the Union County Panthers 19. Now after that blindside block penalty and then the intentional grounding, they're at their own 45 with just 16 seconds left. I think they've got to take a shot here with their quarterback, Colby Watson. Watson takes a snap, rolling to his left. looking downfield. He's got some space to run with it. He's going to pick up about 4 yards. Just under 13 seconds to go here in the first half. Watson was chased again as soon as he got the ball. Third and a country mile for Banks County. Third and about 26 yards. As they huddle up, looking to see what they're going to do here with Colby Watson at quarterback, and Andrew Shockley will be lined up beside him. Maybe try to find him on that angle route once more that netted a 70-yard touchdown, their only points of the game. But he's going to be split out wide to the right side. And a pre-snap penalty. And it's going to be a delay of game on Banks County. And they're just going to continue to keep moving back. I mean, this drive has done nothing but been moved back. They're going to have it third down, and that 10-yard penalty or 5-yard penalty is going to bring up third and 30. Another score update. Fannin still down 10-0 against Modell, and the Andrews squad is beating Swain now 33-7 as a sack is going to be taken by Watson, and that should do it for the first half of play. As the time winds down here in the first half, and Union County takes a 28-7 lead into the halftime. Just a dominant half by Union County's offense and defense as that drive just moved backwards about 60 yards for the Banks County Leopards. So as we hit halftime, it's a 21-point lead for Union County. We're going to take a quick 60-second break, and then the halftime show will follow that.
Union County football is brought to you by the North Georgia News, providing news and sports coverage to Union County for over 100 years. Go Panthers!
Locally owned since 1980, Leon's Flooring is your full-service flooring store with the largest showroom in the area, guaranteed to save you money with over 50 years of total sales experience. The folks at Leon's Flooring are experts in ceramic tile, carpet, hardwoods, and vinyl. Located at 568 Murphy Highway in Blairsville, next to the Mexican restaurant and across from Mike's Seafood. Leon's Flooring, call them today at 706-745-9433. Oh, and by the way, say hello to Diesel while you're there.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by the Family Medical Practice of Thomas Karisny, MD, in Blairsville, serving Union County and the Mountain area. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB as the halftime festivities have gotten underway here at Banks County. Union County with a 21-point lead, a couple of back-to-back-to-back-to-back touchdown drives by Union County, and then that 170-yard touchdown for Banks County. They haven't really been able to get anything going offensively. The defense has played a pretty good game for Banks County, a couple of stops on the first two drives, but the negative 1-yard punt by Banks County really got Union County scoring underway with a Braylon Raiders 16 touchdown run following that immediately, and then right after that, Shockley tied it up at 7, but since then it's been 21 unanswered for Union County. Touchdown run by Caden Tanner, and then a Zach Taylor touchdown reception, and then a 4-yard touchdown run by Caden Tanner once more to make it a 21-point lead. But going into the second half, the Banks County Leopards will get the ball to start it off, so they're going to have to try and get something going. But we had a couple of interviews this week during this this 3-week hiatus that Union County had, in which they haven't played a game since mid-September. They had a couple of bye weeks, actually two in a row, before fall break happens next week, but they'll be playing next week as well. But 3 weeks off really for Union County from the time of the last game's end to today's first snap at 8:17. Union County's had a lot of time to prepare for this game. Banks County, on the other hand, has played a couple of games back-to-back-to-back, but their bye week came a little bit earlier than usual, Banks County's did, and Union County's came at the perfect time of the season right before region play, as this is the first region game for Union County against Banks County and the second Banks County region game. Banks has played their one region game. They lost 55-24 to East Jackson, in which East Jackson really got their number that entire game. Shockley had a good game, but they really just couldn't get anything going on the defensive side of the ball, giving up 55 points. But in this game, they've given up 28 to the Panthers. They were spotted really 7 points given up on that Braylon Raider touchdown run. But this will be the Union County Panthers marching band performing the halftime show first, and then Banks County will follow them. We've got about a 20-minute halftime here in Homer, Georgia. 17:30 to go in the half. But Jeff Batten had a chance to sit down with the head coach, Michael Perry, of the Union County Panthers, about a five-minute interview earlier on this week, recapping the season so far through the first five games, and then going over what's in store for the next five, in which are all region play, starting with this game against the Leopards. So we'll send you to that right now. Then after that, we'll break down a couple of more plays that have happened in this game. And then we also had a chance to talk to Caden Tanner and Gage Barnes, two of the Panthers' premier players, one on the offensive side of the ball and one on the defensive side of the ball. But right now we're going to send you to that interview between Jeff Batten and the head coach of the Union County Panthers, Michael Perry.
Been a couple of weeks since we checked in with Michael Perry, the head coach of the Union County Panthers, but we're glad to have him on the line now as we look back to a 48-7 victory over West Hall a couple of weeks ago, and the Panthers now looking pretty good at 4-1. Michael, I know that it's been a couple of weeks. What were your recollections of the game, and did you walk off the field thinking that you were pretty happy with the effort all the way around?
The best I felt was about our offensive line. Those guys are continuing to just get better and better every week. That really showed because we were able to have a big night. Raider and both Connor Shutnick had a big night running the football. So just really proud of those guys. Defense has been playing great all year. So yeah, it was a nice night. Seems like forever ago. Now we're ready for Banks County tonight.
4-1 as we have the Leopards in our sights up near Homer, Georgia. We'll get to that ball game in just a second. Now, you talked about your two running back tandem of Connor and Braylon. Have you got a strategy right now about who you use in what situation, whether it's a tough yard that you need or whether it's a power sweep that you need? How are you looking at those two guys?
So I consider both those guys power runners, definitely, for sure. And really, it's just whoever's got the hot hand. That's it, how we ride it. Both guys, we're lucky to have both of them. And we play the hot hand, and both of them get plenty of opportunities. And if someone starts doing something really spectacular, we just ride the big boy until he's tired and put the other one in.
Let's talk about wide receivers. Jensen has had a great year so far. Talk about the other guys that you feel like that you have a lot of confidence in, that if you had to get a third and five on a quick slant, they'd be the guys to do it.
Griffin Young, he's been a spark for us all year. He's had a great year for us. Tyler Grassy, really proud of him. He stepped up. He's really stepped up at our tight end position and gotten better and better. He's really mature for how young he is. So really proud of him. And then Zach Taylor, I mean, him and Ethan McBride at our X position, I mean, have done a really good job, specifically in the blocking game. Zach Taylor's a really good blocker. And, you know, Ethan helps us so much out in the kicking game, obviously, as well.
Talking with Michael Perry as we get ready for Banks County and look to go 5-1. And that five wins would be a couple more than you got all of last year. I know that we've talked in the past, Michael, about how much better you think this team's, this version is than over last year. Are the kids believing it now? Can you see a difference in the way that they conduct themselves, not even just on the field, on the practice field, but even in the locker room, the way that they're looking at the season?
Funny, because Banks has a lot of different things. They haven't played a lot of teams like us that really throw the ball a lot, so we had to go back and watch last year's game, and our kids are watching that, and I mean, the kids are like, man, God, we are so much better than we were last year. So I think it's evident. Everybody sees it, knows it, more confident as the weeks go by.
So you like your offensive line, you like your defensive line. I think you like your linebacker core okay. I know that you said that there was a question mark on the secondary. Are you feeling like that all 11 guys are giving you the most of what you could expect?
Definitely. Speaking of the secondary specifically, I tell you what, Sam Page, he is probably the most improved football player on our team. He's also the young man that had that game-saving tackle against Fannin County week one. But I couldn't be prouder of Sam and how he continues to get better. Such a hard worker. He comes to work every day, practice every day, and brings his best. Wilson Walker's another one. Wilson, such a great kid. Big help in our special teams game, too, but just real physical, really sets the tone back there.
You had a key injury with one of the guys that's been getting a lot of minutes on defense. That's Taylor Whitehead. Does it look optimistic that he might be able to rejoin the team in time for the playoffs? Because I know he's had some nice moments so far this year.
Yeah, we're really proud of how much he's grown. And corner is definitely, you're on an island most of the game, so you have to have a quick memory. But he has just gotten so much better as a football player. We're still waiting. We're not sure we'll get him back before playoffs. Sure do hope we can, because he's definitely been a spark for us at corner. Hopefully we'll get Braden Plott back here soon, who will be a big help to our defense as well. He's been hurt all year, so hopefully we'll get him back. So that's the one plus of these 2 weeks, is the ability of getting some of our guys who banged up injured back.
Absolutely. And last question, in order to make the playoffs, we've got to start winning region games, and that starts tonight with Banks County. Tell me what you're looking at, Michael.
Oh, we've harped about everything we've done before this. Doesn't matter at all because, you know, region obviously dictates where you are in the playoff standings. We're going to do everything we can to secure a home playoff bid. Banks was kind of upset, I would say, last week by East Jackson. The Banks.
Kick some butt in the region starting tonight.
Hey, let's do it. Thank you for everything you do, Jeff. Go Panthers.
Union County Football is brought to you by the North Georgia News, providing news and sports coverage to Union County for over 100 years. Go Panthers.
Locally owned since 1980, Leon's Flooring is your full-service flooring store with the largest showroom in the area, guaranteed to save you money with over 50 years of total sales experience. The folks at Leon's Flooring are experts in ceramic tile, carpet, hardwoods, and vinyl. Located at 568 Murphy Highway in Blairsville, next to the Mexican restaurant and across from Mike's Seafood. Leon's Flooring, call them today at 706-745-9433. Oh, and by the way, say hello to Diesel while you're there.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by the Family Medical Practice of Thomas Karizny, MD, in Blairsville, serving Union County and the Mountain area. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli. Providing the best quality of meats in the area. Located between Young Harris and Blairsville.
Constantly challenging ourselves as a college means more learning opportunities, better teaching, more innovative programs, greener facilities, a stronger community, and happier students. Every choice we've made reinforces our mission to help educate, inspire, and empower you. Young Harris College. This is the place where your future unfolds.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Union County Farm Bureau, proud sponsor of Union County football and the Georgia High School Association. Union County Panther football broadcast brought to you by Carter Insurance and Investments in Blairsville, serving the area for over 30 years. Best of luck to the Panthers.
My whole business just went up in flames. But my agent was there before the fire was out. We started a plan. I've got 25 employees who could be out of a job if we didn't get this place running again. My independent agent and auto owner's insurance, they made sure we didn't skip a beat. I mean, we didn't miss a single payroll. That's incredible.
For whatever lies ahead, we're always there.
Now you can find more insurance in Blairsville on Highway 515 across the street from the Home Depot. Call 706-745-2139 for a fast and accurate quote.
So your son or daughter is looking to play sports at the next level, but driving to Atlanta every day for instruction is out of the question. Finally, individual and group training has come to Blairsville. Introducing the HIT Academy inside the gym in Blairsville. You've got to see this place. Sports-specific training for the middle or high schooler or advanced lifting for all ages. It's the HIT Academy inside the gym in Blairsville on the Blue Ridge Highway. Afternoon classes are forming now. Facebook the gym Blairsville to get started.
Touchdown reception of about 30 yards for HIT's fourth of the season. And then another 15-yard touchdown run by Tanner. So those two touchdown runs for the Panthers starting quarterback Caden Tanner are his first two of the season, in which Tanner now has 13 touchdowns total on the season, a very big season for Union County. But one thing that was more expected in this game for Union County was the offensive ground game to get going a little bit more. Union County Panthers, over that three-game win streak, had at least one 100-yard rusher, usually in Braylon Rader, who's had an incredible season for the Panthers, now has eight touchdowns on the season with over 500 rushing yards. But he's been an absolute terror for opposing defenses. But then you look over at Banks County, in which they have Andrew Shockley, who has over 1,400 all-purpose yards with 1,000 rushing and then 400 to go along with that receiving, and also 16 touchdowns now in the season. So both of these teams have two premier running backs on their squad, but the thing that Union County has that Banks County does not have is the play at quarterback, in which Union County has Caden Tanner, but Banks County is rolling out a new quarterback in Colby Watson, who is a Colby Watson's a sophomore, so this is the first time that I've seen him show up on the Max Prep stats, and Watson trying to get his legs up under him. But so far in this game, Union County's pass rush has been premier as usual. The run defense has been great against Andrew Shockley. Other than that 70-yard touchdown, this Panthers defense is playing as expected. And right now we see the Banks County band taking the field performing. Union County, of course, came on before them as the away team. So both of these bands are great for both squads, and you see Banks County now 4-2 on the season, in jeopardy of falling to 4-3 on a three-game losing streak. So they're going to try and get something going here in the second half. They get the ball to start off the second half. For the Banks County Leopards, they're going to want to see better play out of Colby Watson here in the second half of play, but the receivers may not be getting open. We really haven't seen it. But to me, it looks like the offensive line has been a point of emphasis that Banks County has just not had in this game. They've been beaten pretty consistently in this game by Lane Lance, Elijah Haynes, even David Heredia with a couple of pressures in this one. But the Banks County offense has just not gotten anything under them, and I think in the second half they're going to come out trying to run again. They're going to need some better blocking for that to be the case. So 6:30 left here on the halftime clock with the Union County Panthers 21-point lead as the Banks County marching band is out there right now performing at halftime. Banks County, I don't know how they're going to be able to stay in this game. They're giving up 20. They're averaging 29 points per game, but in this one against Union County, who over the past three games has only given up 8 points a game, it's going to be really tough for them to crawl back in this game. But if they can get a first drive touchdown to start the second half, they will be sitting pretty with a good opportunity at stopping the Panthers, which they did on the first two drives as the Panthers were really trying to get their legs up under it. But since then, the Panthers have pretty much dominated this game. And on the previous drive for Banks County, that one penalty on the illegal blindside block on the interception from number 48 for Banks County, and Kaz Oliver has been all over the place, had a sack and then an interception on the next play. Banks County would have started at the Union County Panthers 19-yard line. Instead, they get pushed back to the Panthers 45, and then an intentional grounding called against Colby Watson. And that has really been a huge point of emphasis in this game. The Panthers have played a great defensive game, but the Leopards have also hurt themselves a lot with penalties pre-snap, a couple of encroachment penalties, offsides, a couple of false starts, and then right there, I mean, Colby Watson really had nothing he could do with the ball besides throw it away, but the only hand that was open for him was his left hand, so it was a 15-yard penalty from the point of where he tried to throw the ball away, and that kind of squandered the drive. But I got a chance to sit down with the Panthers starting quarterback, Caden Tanner, and also the Panthers linebacker, one of their best linebackers on the team, and Gage Barnes. So we're going to send you to those two interviews right now. Once again, that's Caden Tanner and Gage Barnes. We'll be back after those interviews. Spencer Mathis alongside Union County Panthers starting quarterback Caden Tanner. Caden, you guys entered the bye week on a three-game win streak. How will you guys keep up that type of success over the second half of the season?
Yeah, we just got to keep the same momentum that we've had coming in from the Towns games, our Mucci games, over the break. We just got to keep the same momentum and we'll be good.
And over that three-game win streak, you guys averaged 46 points per game. Who or what do you credit for that type of offensive production?
The O-line and the running backs have played really good. The O-line's open up the run game huge, and it's just opened up our pass game too, and everything's rolling.
And you've only turned the ball over twice this season. You've thrown 9 touchdown passes. Talk about your individual growth on the gridiron this season.
Yes, I definitely got way more comfortable after the Fanning game, after the first game, way more comfortable, and I'm just really focused on making the right decisions, and practice helps a lot too.
And take us through your mindset going into each and every play, and especially when the play breaks down.
Just go through my reads first, and if the play breaks down, I know I can extend the play with my legs. That's what I try to do, is extend with the legs and find Griffin or Jensen downfield.
And final question for you, Caden. What is going to be the main point of attack going into the Banks County game tonight?
Well, we got to establish a run game pretty quick, just come out and hit them in the mouth, and we can throw screens on them all night if they play how we think they're going to play.
Awesome. Thank you very much. That was Union County Panthers starting quarterback Caden Tanner. Spencer Mathis alongside Union County Panthers senior linebacker Gage Barnes. Gage, the defensive unit so far this season has only given up 12 points per game. Talk about the defense's success over the first half of the season.
We've just really been working hard inside the box, making sure that they can't run the ball on us. We're struggling a little bit down in our corner zone, but we're getting there, and everything's going to get tight.
And you lead the team so far this season with 50 tackles, 13 tackles for loss. Talk about your individual growth on the gridiron.
Well, it's been a long road recovering from hurting my back last season, but I've fixed that, and I've really made sure to keep my body in good health and everything right.
And the final 5 games of the season are, of course, region play. How will you guys stay focused in the toughest part of the schedule?
We're just going to keep doing what we do.
Of course, Banks County is a ground-and-pound type of offensive style. They run behind Andrew Shockley, their star running back. How do you guys feel that you match up against them? And also, what are you guys going to need to do defensively to keep Andrew Shockley in check?
We're not too worried about them physically. We feel like we can definitely dominate on both sides of the ball. Andrew Shockley is a good player, no doubt, but we feel like as soon as the corners can get him back to the inside, that we'll have him under control.
And thank you very much. That was Union County Panthers starting senior linebacker Gage Barnes.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years. For over 30 years, Carter Insurance and Investments has provided the Union County area with quality and competitive products for life, health, and disability insurance, as well as Medicare supplements. As an investment advisor representative, Carter Insurance and Investments can help you build an investment plan that's best for your financial situation. To learn more, stop by and meet our friendly staff. We're located on Young Harris Street across from the post office in Blairsville. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli, providing the best quality of meats in the area. Located between Young Harris and Blairsville. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Union County Farm Bureau, proud sponsor of Union County football and the Georgia High School Association.
For years, your source for sales, parts, accessories, and service for golf carts has been North Georgia Golf Carts. Now they're at a new, more convenient location. Owner Rick Goddard and staff are there to assist you with all your golf cart needs. They sell and service all types of golf carts, from Easy Go to Club Car to Yamaha. And they provide pickup and delivery for any service work. That's North Georgia Golf Carts, now located east of Young Harris near the intersection of U.S. Highway 76 and State Highway 17 North.
Get your prescriptions filled in minutes at Brasstown Pharmacy Drug and Gun in Blairsville. Flu shots, the PCR COVID test, regular COVID test, or antibody test today. Brasstown Pharmacy is your go-to pharmacy for curbside pickup, personalized compounded medications, and more. And we're loaded with a full line of firearms, ammo, and gifts. Brasstown Pharmacy Drug and Gun is the best bang for your buck behind McDonald's in Blairsville. Call or text 706-745-2303.
For years, Bitter Creek Market has been the best little market in the mountains. Now they're even bigger and better with additional room for specialty foods, vegetables, and frozen foods. But don't worry, Bitter Creek Market still has the best selection of quality meats in the area. Their professional butchers prepare the best cuts of meats daily right on site, and Bitter Creek Market grinds their own sausage using only quality cuts of meat. For the gourmet cook, Bitter Creek Market has a wide selection of high-quality food items. And don't forget Bitter Creek Market's deli. Stop by for freshly made sub sandwiches and pork barbecue smoked right on site. They even have homemade potato salad. And they have picnic tables by the creek for your dining convenience. Bitter Creek Market is open Monday through Saturday. Come by and see the friendly staff today. Bitter Creek Market, the best little market in the mountains.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB as the clock operator put on 3 minutes after those two halftime performances by Banks County Band and the Union County Panthers Band. Both of them did great, the Leopards and the Panthers. But the Panthers in this football game lead 28-7 heading into the second half of play, in which the Banks County Leopards will get the ball to start off the second half. The Panthers are going to look to do much of the same as they did on offense and defense in the first half. The Banks County Leopards are going to have to try and pick up their offensive line play here in the second half. Andrew Shockley has really had no space to run behind in this game. Union County Panthers defense has been there on the outside and the inside of the linebacking core and defensive line. And you go back to that Gage Barnes interview, in which Gage Barnes said that they see that Andrew Shockley is a great running back for Banks County, but they're not worried as long as their cornerbacks can come up and make tackles. And we've seen that time and time again in this game with Nolan Thompson making some big tackles, Cade Dockery getting in on the play. Also, Sam Page in the back half alongside Wilson Walker. I mean, this whole Panthers secondary has been great in this game. So has the linebacking core. The Panthers defense in general has been good. But Banks County is really going to want to have a better push on the offensive line in this second half. Union County, of course, with 21 unanswered points, two touchdown runs from Caden Tanner, which is not usual of Caden Tanner. That's his first two rushing touchdowns of the season. He's now up to 12 touchdowns on the season with now three turnovers after that interception by number 48, Kaz Oliver, for Banks County, in which it looked really promising for Banks County at the end of the first half until they called the blindside block penalty, and then they called the intentional grounding on the starting quarterback for Banks County and Kelly Watson. So Banks County moved about 40 or 50 yards back on their previous drive on penalties. So in the second half, they're going to have to shore up their pre-snap penalties, their in play penalties. I mean, they've had a lot of penalties called against them. Union County, pretty few and far between in this game, and they played a clean game. They played a great game, and Union County, of course, because of that, leads by 21 as we get down to under 20 seconds left here in the intermission of this game here in Homer, Georgia. Temperatures drop below 70 degrees. It's a great night, though, here in Homer, Georgia. Not a cloud in sight the entire day, and right now there's no shot of rain. So Panthers will start off the second half up by 21 points, looking to hold on to that lead, especially here on the first drive, as Zuriel Mancias will get things kicked off. The referee's sitting at the Banks County logo at the moment. So we got a couple of score updates from Garland Johnson back at the station in Young Harris, Georgia, 95.1 WJRB. Andrews defeated Swain by a score of 33-7. That score remained the same for over 12 minutes to finish that one off. And then Fannin lost to Modell 24-0. So Fannin County in week one played Union County, and Union won by 7 points, a 14-7 victory to start off the season. A game that we thought was a huge victory for Union County, which it was. I mean, they're 4-1 on the season now. But going back to look at that, at the time we thought that win was a lot bigger because Fannin County has been a better team over the past couple of years than they are this year. They got blanked by Modell 24-0, and Union County is up 28-7 over the Banks County Leopards as Zuriel Mancias will get ready to put toe to leather to start off the second half of play. Back deep to return for Banks County, number 6, Lane Morris. Mancias takes his drop back. Ball placed at the 40-yard line. And Mancias will put toe to leather to start off the second half. We are underway. The kickoff will be fielded at the 14-yard line, down to the 25, and he will be tackled down at the 33. Pretty good return there for Banks County. That was number 8 in Davian Knox, a good return, and another good starting field position spot for Banks County. They've started at least past the 30 on almost every drive besides that one drive where Union County stalled and Wilson Walker punted it inside the Banks County 10-yard line. But other than that, the Banks County Leopards have had pretty good starting field position. They just haven't really gotten anything going. But here in the second half, it could be a different story as the offense makes its way onto the field. One receiver split to the left side and one to the right with 7 on the offensive line here, 2 of them, of course, being tight ends. A handoff to Andrew Shockley to start the second half, and Shockley weaving his way through for a gain of about 7 yards. A nice run there by Andrew Shockley. And pretty good blocking. They had to have 7 blockers there on the play. Banks County did, and they did their part, and Union County got pushed back. So a gain of 8 for Banks County on the first play of the second half. Gage Barnes made the tackle for Union. Now at 55 tackles on the season and counting. Once again, same formation for Banks County. They're going to be relying a lot on Andrew Shockley, but he's walking gingerly up to the snap here. A man in motion and another handoff to Shockley. Takes it to the outside, a nice quick bounce. He's got the edge over Union County, and he's all the way down to the Panthers' 38-yard line. Good blocking by the Banks County offensive line. He's actually down to the Panthers' 36. A good run by Shockley. He got the outside edge immediately. And a huge play for Banks County to start off the second half. So a very good drive brewing here in Homer, Georgia for the Leopards. They're now in Union County Panthers territory as number 8, Davian Knox, makes his way onto the field. The man that just got the kickoff return for Banks County down to the 30-plus yard line. See what the game plan is here inside the Panthers 50-yard line here, actually inside the 40 at the 36. as Knox makes his way back off the field here. Still in their huddle. Clock sitting at 11:03 remaining in the second half of play. As Banks County makes its way to the line of scrimmage here. One receiver split very far out to the left and one to the right with another seven offensive linemen set here. Two of them, of course, being tight ends, but they're all blocking. Another handoff to Shockley, this time to the left side. He's got a first down and more. Nice run by Andrew Shockley, and again, nice blocking for Banks County. A gain of 15 yards. And the Leopards are looking hot out of the gates here to start the second half. All the way down to the Union County Panthers 21-yard line. Leopards go back to their huddle. Of course, the clock's going to stop after every first down in high school football. This time a different formation. Two receivers to the left, but still two tight ends on the set. They motion from left to right. Another handoff to Shockley. He cuts back inside, and another nice, quick, swift gain of six.
Andrew Shockley takes the handoff.
And Shockley is just a great pure runner for this team. I mean, you can just see as soon as he sees the hole, he'll cut right back inside, cutting on a dime to pick up 6 yards on almost every run whenever he has some decent type of blocking, which in a lot of cases in the first half really just was not there. But so far, out of the gates here in the second half, the Banks County Leopards offensive line has done a great job, especially in this set where they have seven on the line. That's Shane Roberts, one of the linebackers for the Leopards at tight end, as a play-action pass roll out to the left side. This is going to be tough for Colby Watson, and that pass is going to be incomplete.
Colby Watson's pass.
Nice coverage there by Seth Rutan. So that play, really, they've ran that a couple of times in the first half. Just anytime you have Colby Watson rolling out to the left with all the pressure coming at him, it's going to be tough to get a throw off. But there, the throw is almost there. It's going to bring up third down and about six for Banks County. Two receivers to the left, and then seven again on the line. Also joining alongside Roberts. Another handoff to Andrew Shockley. He's trying to get the outside. He'll cut back in, cut back outside. A nice run by Shockley down to the 15-yard line. Let's see where they mark him out. He may have ran out of bounds just a little bit before that. And being down by 21, a field goal is not going to do any good. So any four downs here is four down territory for the Banks County Leopards at this point. A nice tackle made by Cade Dockery. It's going to bring up fourth down and about two for the Leopards.
And short for the Leopards.
And the last time they were in a fourth and two or less to go, they did a direct snap to Andrew Shockley. They even took their quarterback Watson out of the game. So we'll see what they do here on fourth and two. Shockley will be the sidecar to Watson's left. Two receivers to the right, seven on the line again. And the cadence, we don't know if that may be a full start or it could be an encroachment by the Panthers defense. Instead, it's going to be a false start. Look to be on their right guard. And that's going to bring up fourth down at seven. It's going to make this fourth down a lot more difficult. And they're down by 3 scores. Scoring a field goal here really wouldn't do any good, so they've still got to stay out there on offense. Fourth and seven coming up for the Leopards. Under 9 minutes to play in the third quarter. This time they're going to have Shockley as the slot receiver with number 5 Roberts lined up in the backfield to the right of Watson. Watson rolls out to the right, pressure coming. It's blocked pretty well. Watson's pass is completed. I don't know if he got to the line to gain. A nice tackle. I don't think he got it. That's going to be a first down for Union County. He did not get the first down. A good play there, but Watson's pass, if that would have been fourth and two, it's a first down. But instead, after the pre-snap penalty, it's a fourth and seven, and a 5-yard gain isn't going to pick up the first down. And the Panthers' offense will come onto the field.
First down, Union County.
Panthers' cornerbacks in tight coverage, but they had a little bit of space there. But Banks County couldn't make the play after the catch, and Union County takes over after the first drive for Banks County in the second half stalls. Andrew Shockley makes his way off the field, limping a little bit gingerly. He's gotten the ball a lot in this game. He's been the bell cow running back for Banks County, of course. Panthers have it first and 10 from their own 15-yard line. Tanner takes a snap and a handoff to Braylon Rader, picks up about a yard. And Banks County's defensive line has played a very good game. Besides that 16-yard touchdown run by Raider on the second or third drive of this game, they've done a great job stopping Braylon Raider for gains of just two or three usually. Panthers quick back to the line. A man in motion is Grasty. Snap over Tanner's head. He can't handle it, and it looks like Banks County is going to recover. A high snap there from Alex Godinez on the Panthers' first drive of the second half, and it just goes out of the reach of Caden Tanner. Would have been a tough catch to make. He tried to, but it also took a weird bounce after he didn't make the original catch. And the Banks County Leopards take over in good territory. This is a lot like the Union County Panthers in the first half, in which they got the ball at the Leopards' 16-yard line. This time the Leopards will get a chance to do the same amount of damage with a touchdown here from within the Panthers' 10-yard line.
First and goal for the Leopards.
They had a good first drive to start the second half. We'll see if they can run the ball inside the red zone here. First play, a handoff to Andrew Shockley. Cuts it back inside, and he's going to pick up
Shockley
about two. Tackle made by the linebacker Elijah Helton for Union County. 7:40 to go here in the third quarter. Banks County a little bit quicker here on this drive. Usually they huddle up after a gain of two or three, but this time they move fast. Two tight ends in motion here for Banks County. Another handoff and a great juke inside by Andrew Shockley. And he picks up three.
Shockley on the carry.
That's going to bring up about third and five. Cooper Ashcraft makes the tackle for the Panthers. Third down and five. A big play here, but it's four down territory. You don't have to get it all here on this third down. They found a little bit of success running the ball, but I think the Panthers are really expecting that. So a play-action pass may catch the Panthers off guard here if the Banks County Leopards want to run one. Under seven to go here in the third quarter of play. Colby Watson, the quarterback. The running back to the right is, of course, Shockley, but there's going to be a timeout before the play. A timeout called by Banks County, and that timeout may be meaningful later on in this game, but we're going to take a quick 60-second break. We'll be back in 60 on 95.1 WJRB.
Union County Panther football broadcast brought to you by Carter Insurance and Investments in Blairsville, serving the area for over 30 years. Best of luck to the Panthers.
When you combine quality products, excellent customer service, and the best prices in the area, the result is Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing. In business since 1963, Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing has served the surrounding area with a variety of home improvement supplies. Everything from vinyl siding in many colors, trim pieces, shutters, soffits, vents, and accessories. Hemp Hill Vinyl Siding and Metal Roofing, located west of Blairsville on Highway 515.
Union County Football is brought to you by Joyce S. Kemp, DMD, providing family and cosmetic dentistry to the Blairsville area. Best of luck, Purple Swarm. Broadcasts of Union County Panther Football brought to you by North Georgia Golf Carts, providing a full range of sales, accessories, service, and parts.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB. Another pre-snap penalty this time against Banks County once more. It's going to push them back further here on third down, so definitely not going to try and get it all here on this third down. It is four down territory with 6:30 to go in the third quarter of play. It'll be third down and about 15 for the Leopards. Well, that's where the quarterback's standing. Third and about 12 for the Leopards. It's a goal-to-go situation. Pass is going to be incomplete. A stick route intended for their slot receiver in number 11 for Banks County and Colin Caudell. Watson's pass, of course, falls incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth down and 11 for Banks County. So a huge play for Banks County here. They failed one fourth down in the second half so far. This one a further one. Last one was fourth and seven, was fourth and two before the pre-snap penalty. They did not convert the fourth and seven. A fourth and 12, they've got to take an end zone shot. Maybe one of their receivers can go up and get a pass from Watson here. They may challenge the freshman Cade Dockery. Watson's pass is just not, even if it was completed, it's not going to be a first down. And in coverage for Union County, perfect coverage. And Union County takes over on offense once more. The safety, Wilson Walker, in perfect coverage on that out route, which even if the pass was completed, it's not picking up a first down for Banks County. Got to take an end zone shot, but the pass protection for the Leopards broke down almost immediately. Panthers take over again with 6:20 to go here in the third quarter of play from about the 10-yard line. As the dramatic music begins to play here. And the dramatic music has came to an end. Two receivers to the right for Union County. They are out there quick. So is the Banks County Leopards defense. First play, a quick pass to the left side. It's going to be a catch made and a first down for Union County down to the 30. And a big gain for the Panthers all the way down to the 33-yard line is where the receiver stepped out of bounds. A nice catch there by Zach Taylor and nice moves after the catch. He's showing off a lot more speed than usual in this game. Usually just a guy that's going to catch the ball inside the red zone. But in this game, he's outraced a couple of Banks County defenders. And that one goes for a gain of about 25 yards for Union County. Goble, the slot receiver for the Panthers, running back to Caden Tanner's left. And a pre-snap penalty. It's going to be a false start against Union County. That's going to push him back 5 yards. A first and 15 will come up instead, and Andrew Shockley is going to make his way onto the field on defense for the Leopards. And with that 33-7 win by Andrews, they moved to 7-0 on the season. And Towns County was absolutely pummeled tonight, a 42-13 loss to Aquinas. Tanner takes a snap, a quick pass to the left side. That's Jensen Gobley. He's going to pick up about 4 right back to where the line of scrimmage was before the pre-snap penalty. That's going to bring up second down and about 11. Goble in this game has been used on short passes a lot. We haven't seen any deep shots intended for Goble, but they may be setting that up here. Up by 21 points. Neither team has scored in a hot minute with 5:45 to go here in the third quarter of play. Banks County has had some opportunities, though. They had a good drive to start off the second half, and then the last drive just went backwards. Tanner takes a snap and a high lofted pass over Jensen Goble's head, the intended receiver. Good coverage by the Banks County defensive back, and if that's an accurate pass, I think that may be picked off. I think Tanner threw that over the cornerback and receiver and Goble on purpose. So a third down coming up for Union County, third and about 11 from the 32-yard line, one running back to the right of Tanner. It's a play-action pass, but Tanner's going to keep it. He's going to try and get the outside edge, but he cannot gain it on Banks County. Number 12 makes the tackle for the Leopards, Brody Stafford. A nice job containing the edge, and that's going to bring up fourth down and 10 for Union County. They're going to bring the punt team out. A play-action pass there, maybe a design quarterback run to the outside. Either way, Tanner tried to take it, but a nice job by number 12, the freshman Brody Stafford, making the tackle in space. Under 5 to go here in the third quarter. Wilson Walker's second punt of the day. Shockley back deep to return for the Leopards. That punt's going to bounce past the 30, inside the 20. Shockley fields it at the 20-yard line. A juke move outside, back in, down to the 25, to the 30, showing off his juke moves. And he's got it an 11-yard return for the Leopards. And that's where Banks County will start their third offensive drive of the second half with 4:39 to go in the third. The Leopards moved the ball well on the first drive, just couldn't get anything going after the turnover that Union County basically tried to give the Leopards something, but they couldn't take advantage. Here they go. They start at the 31-yard line for the umpteenth time in this game. We'll see what they can do here. The dramatic music is back as the offense takes its way onto the field, led by their quarterback, Colby Watson. Going to need some passes over 5 yards here if they want to get back into a game where they're down by 21. 4:39 to go. Dockery on an island, guarding number 4, Caden Watson. Colby Watson takes a snap, a handoff to Shockley, looking left, trying to bounce it outside. He does. He gets the outside edge to the 35, to the 40, to the 50, to the 45, trying to get chased down. Let's see if Union County can get there. And a huge run by the star running back for Banks County, Andrew Shockley. He's tackled inside the five, but that is a humongous gain for the Banks County Leopards. They have it first and goal to go here, first and goal from about the one-yard line. A great job by the Panthers defensive back, tracking him down inside the five. Nolan Thompson again saving a touchdown, but it's going to be tough for Union County to keep Banks County out of the end zone here from within the one-yard line. Oh, they're going to say the five. The PA announcer said the one. So first and goal from the five-yard line. Maybe a little bit easier for Union County. They've been in this situation before, couldn't get anything going. And Shockley is out of the game here on the first play of this drive. Two tight ends in motion from left to right. Two running backs joined alongside Watson. A handoff to number eight for Banks County. That is Davian Knox, and he's tackled down at about the one-and-a-half-yard line, maybe the two. Pretty good run there, a little stretch play to the right side with a lead blocker as the other running back, and Andrew Shockley makes his way back onto the field here.
Elijah.
So Davian Knox comes back off. Elijah Helton made the tackle. Second down and goal from the three-yard line. And you can see after almost every big play that the Banks County Leopards has, it's usually Andrew Shockley, but he's limping a little bit. He's been an absolute warrior tonight for the Banks County Leopards. You can see him walking a little bit gingerly before each and every play, but whenever the ball is snapped, he's ready to go. This time it's going to go past Watson. He'll fall on it, but that's going to be a loss of about 17 yards. And a third and 20 will be the subsequent next play after a bad snap by the center for Banks County. With 3 minutes to go in the third quarter, that's something you can't have. They were with inside the five-yard line. And now you got third and goal from the 20. See what the game plan is here. Last time we saw a five-yard out on about third and 12, and then we saw another one on fourth and goal from the 12. So they've got to try and see if they can get something going into the end zone here on a deep pass coming from Watson, which they just haven't attempted in this game. And it looks like there'll be a timeout by Banks County. So we're going to take a quick 60-second break here on 95.1 WJRB.
Locally owned since 1980, Leon's Flooring is your full-service flooring store with the largest showroom in the area, guaranteed to save you money with over 50 years of total sales experience. The folks at Leon's Flooring are experts in ceramic tile, carpet, hardwoods, and vinyl. Located at 568 Murphy Highway in Blairsville, next to the Mexican restaurant and across from Mike's Seafood. Leon's Flooring, call them today at 706-745-9433. Oh, and by the way, say hello to Diesel while you're there.
Check out North Georgia Water Sports in Blairsville for all of your watercraft wants and needs. Offering inventory loaded with new and used watercraft, including Avalon, Tahoe, Tracker, and Sun Tracker boats. Whatever you want, they got. North Georgia Water Sports also offers a service department with highly trained technicians during all business hours. Don't forget to winterize your boat at North Georgia Water Sports. Call 706-835-1222. Visit NorthGeorgiaWaterSports.com or stop by 2132 Murphy Highway in Blairsville.
Spencer Mathis back here on 95.1 WJRB as the Banks County Leopards face a third and goal from the 20-yard line, down by 21 points. They got to get a touchdown on this drive as the quarterback will roll out to the left side, looking into the end zone, and a great play by the Panthers defensive back. Could have been intercepted, but just a little bit underthrown on the ball from Colby Watson. Intended for Caden Watson, but instead it falls to the dirt. Fourth down and goal from the 20-yard line. And that's something that they haven't done in this game, is take a deep shot. That time they had an opportunity, might as well take it. So instead it's going to bring up fourth and goal from the 20. And from here I think they're going to maybe try and attempt a field goal from Iram Lopez. So a field goal attempt coming up here for the Leopards, down by 21 points. This, if they do make it, will bring them within 18. And before that, we're going to see another timeout taken by Banks County. So we're going to take another 60-second break here on 95.1 WJRB.
Constantly challenging ourselves as a college means more learning opportunities, better teaching, more innovative programs, greener facilities, a stronger community, and happier students. Every choice we've made reinforces our mission to help educate, inspire, and empower you. Young Harris College, this is the place where your future unfolds.
Fry Family Dry Cleaners in Blairsville specializes in deep cleaning and efficiency. Not only do they take the basics, but they also work with rugs, comforters, draperies, and other household items. Now featuring a drive-thru for contactless pickup and drop-off. Not to mention a wash, dry, and fold service. Drop it off. When you pick it up, it'll be folded, sorted, and bagged. Spry Family Dry Cleaners, cleaning up our community, one garment at a time. Located in Blairsville at 46 Hunt Martin Street, across from Cochran Funeral Home.
So a long field goal attempt coming up here for Iram Lopez, and that one is going to be way off. So Banks County uses two timeouts within two plays of each other, and they stay with the same decision to try and take a field goal. That one, a 37-yarder, was not particularly close, just a bit outside, and Union County will take over on offense once more. And even if you hit that field goal, you're still down by 18 points. I get that it's fourth down and goal from the 20-yard line, but that's one that you might still want to go for, because making it an 18-point game isn't really going to do anything. You're still down by three scores regardless. But either way, it's 28-7 still, and Union County takes over again. But Banks County's defense has came to play here in the second half. 2:21 to go in the third. The Panthers will start first and 10 from their own 20. Two receivers to the left and two to the right here. Tanner takes a snap, a quick handoff to Raider. And he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. He's still up on Raider somehow. Gets stuffed at the line of scrimmage, but he's down for about a gain of two, and there's going to be a late flag again. Not sure what the flag's going to be here. It was along the sidelines. They may call something like a late hit here or an unnecessary roughness penalty on Banks County. We'll see what they call. Was a gain of about two for UC. So it's going to be a penalty against Banks County, and Union County will be moved up for a free first down. And the penalties in this game are at least 10 for Banks County.
First down.
And that has really killed their momentum in any situation they've had, especially on the last drive, that false start and then the bad snap. They've been inside the Panthers 10 twice here in the second half, but no points to show for it. Tanner takes a snap, looking left only. And a pass intended for Jensen Goble falls incomplete. Second down and 10 coming up with 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Union County now at the 40-yard line. A defensive battle here in the second half so far.
Second down.
No offense has really got their feet under them here. Banks County's moved from the 20 to the 20, but once they get inside the red zone, there's really nothing going for them. Second and 10, a sidecar to Tanner's right. Tanner looking for an option play. He's going to pitch it back to Braylon Raider down to the 45-yard line, a gain of about five.
Number 12, Brody Stafford.
Little option play in which Tanner had the opportunity to either keep the ball and run with it or throw it back to Braylon Raider, who was trailing behind him. And he does the right thing, pitches it back to Raider for a gain of five. So a third down coming up for Union County. At their own 46-yard line. Four down linemen for Banks County. This time it's a designed QB run with another guy in besides the quarterback, and that is number six for Union County and Griff Young. He's all the way down to the 20. Cuts back inside to the 15. He's still on his feet. Blockers ahead of him. Down to the 10, down to the 5. He's still going, fighting his way into the end zone, and he's down. So close to the end zone. Almost an incredible touchdown play, but instead it's a huge gain for Griffin Young. An incredible run for Griff Young on the quarterback design run in which they took out Caden Tanner on that play, and blockers were ahead of Young, and he picks up a huge chunk of yardage, a gain of about 59. And Union County now first down and goal to go. This is Braylon Raider territory here. Hand off to Raider, trying to find his way into the end zone, and he's going to be tackled at the inch yard line. Second down and goal now from within an inch. Clock winding down, under 50 seconds to go here in the third quarter of play. Wilson Walker got him, or Griffin Young got him down here all the way down to the one. Here's a fake handoff to Braylon Raider, and keeping it for Union County is Caden Tanner, his third touchdown run of the game. and Union County up 34-7. Tanner, coming into this game, mind you, had zero touchdown runs on the season. Today he's got three. That one, a play-action pass where he just took it to the left side and ran into the end zone. So the Panthers now up, a chance to go up 35-7. They lead by 27 here, barring this extra point by Ethan McBride, who has been nearly perfect all year, just the one missed extra point. It may have been blocked in week two versus Lumpkin. The hold by Tanner, the extra point by McBride is up, and it is good. And Union County up now by 28 with under 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. We'll be back in about 60 seconds here on 95.1 WJRB, the voice of the Union County Panthers.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by the family medical practice of Thomas Karisny, MD, in Blairsville, serving Union County and the Mountain area. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Nelson Tractor Company of Blairsville. Nelson Tractor Company has been providing value to our customers for over 60 years. Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli, providing the best quality of meats in the area, located between Young Harris and Blairsville.
So Zuriel Mancias on to kick it off again for Union County. And that ball is going to bounce down to the Leopards' 34-yard line, where it will roll out of bounds, and that's going to be a penalty against Union County on the kickoff. But on that previous drive, a beautiful touchdown run by Caden Tanner, his third of the day, in which he spun to the left side and got into the end zone. And the Panthers up now by 28 with just 39 to go in the third quarter. The Leopards will start first and 10 from their own 35-yard line. Down now by 28 points. They've got to get something going. They need points on this drive. They've been close to the end zone, but the Panthers' defense, once they get inside that red zone, has just been just too good for the Banks County Leopards to handle. So the Leopards here from the 20 to the 20, they've done a great job here in the second half, but once they get inside the red zone, it's no go. Colby Watson takes a snap, a quick handoff there to Andrew Shockley, who somehow is stopped in the backfield immediately, but somehow finds his way back for what should have been a loss of five. It's only a loss of three, and that's really all he can do. The Panthers' defensive line was in the backfield immediately. And Shockley, I believe, is still down on the play here. So as the trainers tend to Andrew Shockley, we're going to take a quick break here on 95.1 WJRB. Hopefully Andrew Shockley is okay for the Leopards.
For over 30 years, Carter Insurance and Investments has provided the Union County area with quality and competitive products for life, health, and disability insurance, as well as Medicare supplements. As an investment advisor representative, Carter Insurance and Investments can help you build an investment plan that's best for your financial situation. To learn more, stop by and meet our friendly staff. We're located on Young Harris Street across from the post office in Blairsville.
Check out Sunrise Grocery in Blairsville, not only the oldest business in Union County. Sunrise Grocery was also named the most charming general store in the South by Southern Living Magazine. Swing by and snag some world-famous peanuts, local produce, and goods, not to mention Jason's highly sought-after photography and Jessica's homemade soaps and candles. That's Sunrise Grocery in Blairsville at 7568 Gainesville Highway, 706-745-5877.
So T's and P's here for Andrew Shockley as he's still down at the 32-yard line. And he has gotten the ball so much in this game for Banks County. He's done all he's could. He's fought as hard as any player on the field tonight, probably the hardest out of anybody on either squad. But Shockley's still down at the 32. Finally getting back up to his feet, walking off the field with a little bit of help. He's walking gingerly still. He's been walking like that since the second quarter. And he's still gotten the ball a lot. He's made some huge plays for Banks County, but It's been tough for him. It's been tough sledding for Banks County in general with nowhere to go for Shockley. That play, that last play, really hurt him there. And luckily, a good thing for Banks County is he's walking off the field under his own power. He looks to be in decent shape here. So hopefully he'll be ready to go for next game. I don't think there's really any reason for Banks County to put him back in this one. Second down and about 13 coming up. A new running back in the game for Banks County is Davian Knox, and he's going to pick up about six. And that should do it for the third quarter of play. 10 seconds left here in the third as the time will just continue to wind down. Davian Knox should be the bell cow running back for the rest of this game as Cooper Ashcraft makes the final tackle of the third quarter, and that'll take us into the final 12 minutes. Union County up 35-7 over the Banks County Leopards here on 95.1 WJRB. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Union County football is brought to you by the North Georgia News, providing news and sports coverage to Union County for over 100 years. Go Panthers!
Locally owned since 1980, Leon's Flooring is your full-service flooring store with the largest showroom in the area, guaranteed to save you money with over 50 years of total sales experience. The folks at Leon's Flooring are experts in ceramic tile, carpet, hardwoods, and vinyl. Located at 568 Murphy Highway in Blairsville, next to the Mexican restaurant and across from Mike's Seafood. Leon's Flooring, call them today at 706-745-9433. Oh, and by the way, say hello to Diesel while you're there.
For brought to you, bringing you this game here on 95.1 WJRB, and also Ridgeline TV for filming this game. Wouldn't have it any other way. Ridgeline TV does a great job with John Moon being the head of this company. He's done great. He's comes to almost every single Union County Panthers game, and he brings you this live footage of the game. Banks County coming up here to start the fourth quarter, a third and six, down by 28 points with the running back Davian Knox in the backfield. So third down and six. Another handoff to Davian Knox. He's going to pick up about two. Still pushing the pile a little bit forward. That's going to be a gain of three. And that's going to bring up fourth down for the Leopards. As number 11 for Banks County limps off the field, and Colin Caudell, he'll make his way back. But a fourth down and about three to go for the Leopards here. Nearing midfield. They're at their own 42-yard line. But at this point in the game, you've got to go for it. No Andrew Shockley, though. It's going to be tough sledding here for Banks County, but if they can get it. A fourth down and four. Davian Knox, the running back, to the right. And it looks like another pre-snap penalty against Banks County. Looked like almost the entire offensive line moved early. That's going to make it a fourth and nine. And they'll be within their own 40-yard line now at the 38. And we'll see what the game plan is here. Fourth down and nine now. Davian Knox makes his way off the field. Maybe a punt coming here from the Leopards, and it will be. Bad snap on the punt. Punter somehow gets it off, and that one's going to go about 10 yards, but it takes a Banks County roll down to the 43-yard line where it'll be touched, and that's where Union County will take over on offense. Up by 28 points, and it looks to be a winding clock here. No, the clock operator just didn't stop the clock in time. 10:21 to go here in the fourth quarter of play. Union County with the lone touchdown here in the second half, a touchdown run by Caden Tanner. A four-yard touchdown run. He's got 2 4-yard touchdown runs in this game. Three on the season now, all three in this game. And that is how Union is up by 28 points, along with great defense. First play of this drive, a handoff to Raider, fighting his way through the tackles for a gain of about four. And this is a game in which usually Union County always relies on their running backs, especially Braylon Raider. We haven't seen any Connor Shucknick in this game. Or at least in the first couple of quarters. We may see him here in the fourth, but Raider really hasn't gotten the ball as much as expected coming into this game. I think Tanner's done a great job spreading the ball around and getting a couple of first downs and also running the ball. As that looks to be Connor Shucknick now in. He's got a first down, fighting hard all the way down to the 35-yard line, carrying a Banks County Leopard on his back. He's breaking a couple of tackles, and now the Panthers are within the Banks County 40. Nice run there for Union County. As the Panthers offense looks over to the sideline, really in no hurry. 9:30 or less to go here in the fourth quarter of play with a 28-point lead. Slow the pace down, try and waste as much time as possible in this one. Shucknick once again lined up to Tanner's right. He'll take the handoff, and that's going to be a gain of 8. So quick, fast yards for Union County, but that was actually Griffin Young that time. Under 9 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter of play. The clock continues to run. So Union County again huddling up, usually not the case, usually a high-tempo offense, a very quick attack, but in today's game, in this fourth quarter, they're going to be as slow as possible, under 8:30 to go here in the fourth quarter of play. Shucknick lined up to Tanner's left. Snap handoff to Connor Shucknick. He's got a first down down to the 20-yard line, and he'll try and truck his way through a Banks County defender, but he makes a tackle at the 20. A first down for Union.
Number 16, Zach Dickey.
And the tackle made there by number 16, Zach Dickey.
First down.
Union County moving the ball with Will here on this drive in the fourth quarter with Connor Shucknick at running back. Under 8 to go in the fourth quarter. Shucknick the lone setback, another handoff to Shucknick up the middle, an inside zone handoff, and that one goes for maybe a yard, maybe back to the line of scrimmage. I think it'll bring up 2nd and 10 for Union. Once again, they'll huddle up.
75, base nine on the stop.
Clock moving down fast. Jensen Goble in motion. Tanner takes a snap. It's a play-action pass looking deep into the end zone, and it is going to be caught for a touchdown, and Union County has put up over 40 once more. A touchdown catch for the Panthers, and they lead now 41-7 over the Banks County Leopards, and that was number 6 for Union County, Griffin Young. And right off the snap, you could see him. He had the cornerback beat. He called for the ball, and Caden Tanner put it exactly in the breadbasket like he needed to. And Union County has a chance to go up 42-7, barring this extra point from Ethan McBride. A beautiful throw by Caden Tanner. Tanner has accounted for all but one touchdown in this game, running for 3 and throwing for 2. Huge game for Caden Tanner. And McBride's extra point is up, and it is good. Union County up 42-7, a 35-point lead over the Leopards, with 7:10 to go here in the fourth quarter of play in Homer, Georgia.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Bitter Creek Market and Deli, providing the best quality of meats in the area, located between Young Harris and Blairsville.
Constantly challenging ourselves as a college means more learning opportunities, better teaching, more innovative programs, greener facilities, a stronger community, and happier students. Every choice we've made reinforces our mission to help educate, inspire, and empower you. Young Harris College, this is the place where your future unfolds.
Broadcasts of Union County Panther football brought to you by Union County Farm Bureau, proud sponsor of Union County football and the Georgia High School Association. Union County Panther football broadcast brought to you by Carter Insurance and Investments in Blairsville, serving the area for over 30 years. Best of luck to the Panthers.
Kickoff by Zuriel Mancias, and that one goes out of bounds once more. Maybe a squib kick, maybe an onside kick. Cannot really tell in this game, but the one thing that we do know is that Banks County, ever since that 70-yard touchdown reception from Andrew Shockley, has been blanked out since the 158-minute mark in the first quarter of play. Since then, it's just been all Union County. 35 unanswered points for the Panthers. It was once tied at 7.
Foul down on the 35-yard line, first down.
And Andrew Shockley makes his way off the field, but he was on the field for the kickoff, which is good news for Banks County moving forward. Banks County starts first and 10 from the 35-yard line with the main tailback, Davian Knox, now at running back. Panthers linebackers are creeping near the line of scrimmage here. Let's see if they bring the blitz. It's a handoff to Davian Knox. He's got a gain of about 3, and he stood up. Still fighting forward, though, and he's going to end up picking up about 6. A nice run by Davian Knox. Freshman running back for the Banks County Leopards, but he's done a great job continuing to turn his legs and pick up as many yards as possible. Even though he was stood up after a gain of just 3, he finds his way for a gain of 7. About 6:30 to go here in the fourth quarter of play. The Panthers linebackers stood him up there at about the 42-yard line. Colby Watson, the quarterback, of course, with Knox lined up to his right. He'll take the snap, rolling out right for the first time in this game. And he completes the pass. A nice catch there made by the Banks County receiver, and that's going to be enough for a first down. Number 11 for Banks County and Colin Caudell. And for some reason, that's the first time in this game that we've seen them even attempt to roll out Colby Watson to the right side. He's been rolling out to the left on nearly every play, in which it's going to be a tough arm angle to try and throw a ball as a right-handed quarterback rolling out to the left against this Panthers pass rush. But there, a nice throw by Colby Watson and a first down for the Leopards. They're nearing the 50-yard line. Man in motion is number 4, Caden Watson. Colby Watson takes a snap, a handoff to Davian Knox, and he's going to be stood up in the backfield immediately. Right back to the line of scrimmage, and that's going to bring up 2nd and 10. The entire Panthers defensive line and linebacking core was there. Looked to be led by number 40, David Heredia. And he's done a great job setting the edge this season for the Panthers. Usually the 3-down linemen for Union County is Elijah Haynes, Lane Lance, and David Heredia, and they've just done great alongside the 3 linebackers on this squad. So 2nd down and 10 coming up for the Banks County Leopards. Knox lined up to Watson's left. 2 receivers split out wide, 2 tight ends. Hand off to Davian Knox, and he's going to gain about 1 or 2. They'll mark him at the 50-yard line. Huge tackle made there by Union County, a hard hit. And a Panthers player slow to get up. It's Gage Barnes, but he's back up on his feet. And a 3rd down and 8 will ensue for the Banks County Leopards. 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this game. Union County still up by 35. Leopards out of timeouts, but at this time really does not matter. Knox again the tailback, 2 receivers to the left, and then the 2 tight end set. Play action pass, and that one is going to be completed for no gain. Completed number 4, that's Caden Watson, and a 4th down and 8 will come up. Let's see. They'll probably punt the ball away here, down by 35. Really no chance of coming back in this game. No gain on the bubble screen reception by Caden Watson. See if they punt the ball away here at midfield. Or maybe they just try and test out what they have on the offensive side of the ball moving forward. Not quite sure exactly what happened to Kane Griffith. He was the starter before this game. Don't really have too much news on Banks County, the Leopards themselves. So number 10, Colby Watson, of course, for the time being the starting quarterback, as he takes a snap, a rollout to the right again on 4th down and 8. He's got a little bit of time. He throws it, and it's nearly intercepted by Wilson Walker. Great coverage, and that one was just thrown into double coverage intended for Caden Watson. And Wilson Walker will get the pass deflection for Union County. And a running clock here in Homer, Georgia. The clock is now nearing 3 minutes left in the game. Union County's offense will take over once more at the 50-yard line. They've scored twice here in the second half of play. 3:05 to go. See if the Panthers keep their original starters out here. No, they don't. It looks like Cade Dockery is going to be the quarterback for Union County here on what should be the final drive of the game. Under 3 minutes to go. So Cade Dockery, the quarterback for Union County, now wearing number one, usually number 16. First play of this drive is a handoff, and it's fumbled. See who they give the recovery to, and it's Banks County. So a fumble by Connor Shucknick, and Banks County takes over. But luckily for Union County, that one really doesn't matter as much, but I'm sure they're going to chew off Connor Shucknick's ear over there on the sideline, but it should be fine. They're up by 35 with 2 minutes to go here with a running clock, and Banks County's offense will take over at about their own 47-yard line. See if they can get something going here on what should be the final drive of the game. Thought maybe Union right there could close this one out, but first play fumble. Three turnovers now in this game for Union County, but the Leopards offense just has not been there tonight. First play of the drive, a handoff to Davian, and that is going to be a gain of about a yard for Davian Knox.
Knox, the ball carrier.
Really nowhere to go there for Davian Knox, and the Panthers know that it's going to be a handoff, and Banks County's offensive line just can't contain this Panthers pass rush or run-stopping ability. With a minute 30 to go, I think both teams are content with running this ball out, trying to get out of here with no injuries. Surprised still to see the amount of starters out here for both teams in a game like this. A 35-point deficit for the Leopards. Watson takes the snap, another handoff to Davian Knox to the left side, and he's going to be stood up by David Heredia and another Panthers linebacker. So that tackle will be credited to David Heredia and Wilson Walker, the Panthers safety, and that'll bring up third down and about 12. A loss of two on the play, a tackle for loss for Union County. And that's something that they've actually excelled at in every single position this season. Cornerback Seth Rutan, 13 tackles for loss. And then you got Gage Barnes coming into this game, also 13 tackles for loss. Cooper Ashcraft, another linebacker with 12. So they've done a great job tackling the opposing running backs in the backfield. Clock under 40 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter of play. And that one is going to be an early snap there, but it's going to be recovered by number 10 for the Leopards and Colby Watson. And that should do it. Watson was not expecting the snap, and that should be the final play of the game. Luckily, he falls on it. Now a turnover for Banks County as both teams shake hands at midfield, and Union County walks out of here again with another victory in which they put up more than 40 points. So Union County with a 42-7 victory over the Leopards in this game, and just an absolutely dominant performance for Union County, both offensively and defensively, but especially on the defensive side of the ball. They did a great job keeping the star running back Andrew Shockley at bay after the 2 minute mark in the first quarter, in which they had the game tied at 7 after a 70-yard touchdown reception by Shockley. But after that, I mean, 35 unanswered points for Union County. To recap the scoring in this game, the first touchdown of the game was a Braylon Raider 16-yard touchdown run. That put the Panthers up 7-0. Following that, we had the Shockley 70-yard touchdown reception, and then all Panthers from there on out. A 4-yard touchdown run by Caden Tanner, and then a 30-yard touchdown reception by Zach Taylor, his fourth of the season. Following that was another 15-yard touchdown run by Caden Tanner. We saw one more touchdown run by him. He had three on the day. An absolutely dominant performance for Caden Tanner. And then the final touchdown of the game was a Griffin Young touchdown on a pass from Caden Tanner. So Tanner was just all over the place, running, throwing. He continues his success at quarterback for Union County. And the Panthers, with four straight victories, where their offense puts up over 40 points. I mean, a 49-7 victory at Towns, a 42-10 victory in Armershey, and then a 48-7 victory against West Hall a couple of weeks ago at home. And then you see him come over here to Banks County after a long delay in which they didn't get off the bus until 2 hours after they were supposed to. A delayed start, but Union County still comes to play. A 42-7 victory over the Banks County Leopards, and that's going to do it here from 95.1 WJRB. I'm Spencer Mathis, and in case I do not see you again, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.